Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Another incredibly important worldwide broadcast lined up for you on this Wednesday, the second day of May 2012 transmission. I'm Alex Jones, your host. We're going to have Dr. Steve Pachinik joining us in the second hour, and we're going to open the phones up for most of that hour. I'm really trying to get to more of your calls because they're always so informative. But I'm going to open the phones up for U.S. military in the second hour, specifically Afghan vets, because I can't tell you how many emails come in. I'm going to be honest with you. I don't have an email. They set me up emails. Somehow it gets out. I end up spending all my time trying to read my email. I don't know how other big websites do it. How does the Drudge Report, that probably gets, you know, five times the traffic we get, how do they do it? How does the Daily Caller, how does WorldNet Daily, how do they do it? So I just use text messages on my phone, and I use IMs to the crew, and they've all got emails. So what happens is they bring me in big piles of interesting emails. So when I say I'm getting emails, I am. I'm just reading everybody else's. And I get into everybody's accounts. I just, you know, use everybody else's email around here. It's quite a mess. Quite a mess. And I'm really digressing into a big frustration point in my life. I don't know how I manage the information. Quite frankly, I don't. And that's why I've told my crew that we're putting out so much info that I want to pull back and focus on quality, not even quantity. And even our stuff that isn't our best quality is better than my best quality 10 years ago. So we're moving in the right direction, but it makes my head spin. But I'm digressing. It's one reason the show's good, one reason it's bad. I start thinking about troops sending me emails, and then it turns into a whole discussion I was having this morning about the nightmare of email. But hundreds of emails have come in. It's a meme, because we weren't even talking about troops in Afghanistan, saying none of them buy the bin Laden killing. I told you I've talked to a Navy SEAL who has a friend who's in SEAL Team 6. They believe their helicopter was blown up, both of them. The one at the site of the staged Easter Bunny bin Laden killing. And just love to say Easter Bunny. I don't know why. Some people have like Tourette syndrome and stuff. I guess I have Easter Bunny syndrome. But anyways, continuing here. it's just ridiculous. All this New World Order bull is just total mythology is my point. And nothing's more ridiculous than the Easter Bunny. But you ever had family gets mad at you because you won't lie to your kids about Easter bunnies and Santa Claus and tooth fairies? Side issue. I guess you're a conspiracy theorist if you don't believe in Santa Claus. But I'm digressing now completely off the reservation. I've got all these emails from troops that are not buying it. But if troops agree with the bin Laden story, or if Navy SEALs want to call in and correct me, see, I'm so busy, I was put in touch with former and current Navy SEALs that wanted to expose a bunch of info by former head of the Screen Actors Guild, a pretty high-powered media person, and I never even called the guy's number. That's my problem. I'm just going in too many directions. I just remembered that ball I dropped. And now it's gotten to the point of all I think about is all the balls I'm dropping. And I've never really been like that. It's just that now all the information's coming in, and it's like I'm Robbie the Robot with smoke coming out of my ears. And I know that's how you are as well, with your children and work and taxes and illnesses and trees falling on your house and the dog biting the neighbor and cats and dogs living together. Biblical, end of the world type stuff, to quote one of my favorite comedies, Ghostbusters. Mr. Gopher, nothing to worry about, just some plastic explosive. That, of course, is Caddyshack.
You know, some people just don't belong. How about a Fresca?
We'll be right back.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
4, 5, 6, even $7 a gallon? According to fuel industry insiders and economic experts, those are the forecasted fuel prices, with no end in sight. Fight back fuel prices with a fuel saver from airfusionsystems.com. These fuel savers can save you from 20 to 40%. They're designed to fit any vehicle, from compacts to SUVs to transport trucks. The fuel saver works on all gas, diesel, even propane engines. Easy do-it-yourself installation in about 15 minutes. And the best part? No engine modifications, no computer chipping, no running wires, no chemicals, no water, no running costs, and no maintenance. And these fuel savers come complete with all parts and accessories. See how it works at airfusionsystems.com, spelled A-I-R-F-U-S-I-O-N, systems.com. Or call 888-887-9981, 888-887-9981. Fuel savers from airfusionsystems.com. Save fuel, save money, save earth.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Okay, here's what's going to happen today. Or at least, here's what we hope is going to happen. I am going to, right now, just go over news headlines and complete the ritual of failure when I get two or three in. And begin a rant, and then I'm going to give the phone number out, and then everyone's going to sit on hold. And then I'm going to get into the second hour and start stuttering and gibbering because I've got so much information that I want to go over. Okay, I'm in a comedy mood today, and I don't know why, but we're going to have an interesting transmission today. We are going to have open phones for the military, namely Afghanistan veterans. When Steve Pachinik is on the broadcast, Dr. Pachinik, psychiatrist, government overthrower, assassin, and of course co-author of many Tom Clancy books. And he has talked about here on the air the fact that bin Laden was dead back in 2002, and of course the CIA and the meeting with him at the American hospital in Dubai, all of that came out on CBS News after Dr. Pachinik had talked about it. Then Walter Cronkite came out and said they had him on ice and were going to roll him out. And so did Madeleine Albright, former Secretary of State. So very credible. And there was a giant disinfo operation last year when we came out within an hour of Osama bin Obama and announcing that he was a superhero and had directed the SEAL team with live cam feeds. Of course, 2 days later, they admitted that was a total lie. And the Situation Room photo was a lie. But they did throw his body in the ocean along with the Loch Ness Monster. You should believe them. You really should believe a group of people that ship hand grenades and fully automatic machine guns by the tens of thousands to Mexico to blame the Second Amendment, and still blame the Second Amendment even when caught. I mean, these are nice people, so they wouldn't lie to us. And, of course, just ask the Navy SEALs. Oh, the helicopter blew up on the ground. Witnesses said that they saw him get on board and it blow up. But the government says nobody died. But then there was another helicopter went down with the rest of SEAL Team 6 who'd been on the mission, and they died. And of course, they lied about that mission and said that they had were sending them out to save Rangers. And then it just blew up. But, of course, there wasn't a mission to save Rangers, because the Rangers and others said there was no mission to save Rangers. Oh, you guys didn't go along with the lie. Well, we don't know why we packed them on a old National Guard Chinook and flew them out there, or why we broke protocol and packed them all on one aircraft. Just never mind all that. You know, it's like Pat Tillman. He died fighting Al-Qaeda, charging up a hill. The SEALs died going to save the Rangers. Doesn't matter if at every step the story's a lie. Doesn't matter if they murdered Pat Tillman because, well, we know because the Army colonel, the coroner, wouldn't lie. Oh, will he end up like one of the guys working on Breitbart's case? Dying of poisoning, but that's not suspicious. Again, I should just believe known liars. I shouldn't be a conspiracy theorist and question known liars. Does that mean the government and corrupt corporations are always doing something bad? No. And I wish it was just good old-fashioned incompetence and things. And there is some of that. But so many times it turns out the worst is actually the case. I want to believe things aren't this bad. I want to believe things aren't degenerating. I live in this country. I love this country. I don't want to toot my horn, but it doesn't, I mean, my entire family on both sides, it doesn't get any more Americana. Mayflower, 1776, battle for Texas independence, raising Colonel Travis's son, and on and on and on. It's ridiculous how much of my family's been in the military and intelligence and every other system for this republic, going back on both sides. I am a thoroughbred Americana, dyed-in-the-wool American. It doesn't, you just can't beat it. And I say that because I'm sick of people saying I'm anti-America because I don't like the criminals running our government. I'm sick of people wrapping themselves in the American flag and lecturing me all day about how my basic liberties that people fought and died for are a bunch of trash. And I'm angry about it. And I'm sick of it. And I want my republic back. I want my due process and my private property and my family rights and my prosperity and my religious rights. I want it all and I demand it now. And I will fight for it, you better believe. And to quote John Paul Jones, the Scot, people say Jones is Welsh. He took the name Jones. To quote that great Scot, I have only begun to fight. Well, let me tell you, we got T-shirts coming out and bumper stickers with "We have just begun to fight." Infowars.com, because this is it. See there, I didn't get to one article before I started ranting. It's just overwhelming. It's overwhelming, the amount of insanity. And I've self-analyzed. I know why I get so angry at the start of the show. Because I read this stuff all night. I read it in the morning. I get in here. They bring me piles of other news. And it's just like, there's no way to cover all this. There's no way. But let's give it a try. Rupert Murdoch's Fox broadcast license targeted by U.S. Ethics Group, which is basically a Clintonista front. The Washington-based ethics watchdog is calling on federal regulators to revoke News Corporation's 27 Fox broadcast licenses. And they're talking about arresting his son and others now. This is the same Justice Department caught shipping hand grenades and machine guns into Mexico, and the memo said to blind the Second Amendment. Gee, like I needed to know that 2 years ago when we first started covering this. Actually, 6 years ago, but then hardcore a year and a half ago. It's all in the federal documents. See, and then every time I talk about this, I see comments and people saying, Alex, how dare you defend News Corp, you pig? Look, if they can bring down News Corp, if they can shut down Rush Limbaugh like they've been trying to do, you notice this is happening everywhere? They're going to be able to shut down everybody who isn't basically totally anti-gun. Look, News Corp acts like they're conservative because they understand that's a market. I get that. I know that his properties overseas, you know, push globalism, all this stuff. I understand it. I could care less for Rupert Murdoch. But let me tell you something. The fact that they're trying to destroy him right now means there's no counterbalance. The left-right paradigm is a fraud, but within the power structure, it is a left-right debate and a left-right system. And if we get a total one-party system, if they're able to shut down News Corp or basically take it over and turn it into globalist light, look out. And you notice you're seeing the internet censorship now, the CISPA, all of it's happening now. You suddenly see the checkpoints on the highways. You suddenly hear about the 450 million hollow point, you know, soft tip 40 cals and military checkpoints and TSA searching bags on highways. It's here. And they're probing. They're testing. Oh, we're going to secretly arrest you under NDAA, but we're not going to implement that. Well, maybe we will. Well, yeah, we are watching you without warrants illegally. Yeah, we are launching wars without congressional approval. Yeah, we did set up a rural council. Yeah, we are going to ban farm kids doing chores. Yeah, we are going to shut down your local power plant without law, just because we're going to make more money off of it once the competition is shut down. I mean, I could go on and on. I mean, it is a all-out offensive right now. And you see the attacks on media and the attacks on anything that's alternative. And sure, to those of us who are really awake, Fox News is not an alternative. The only thing that you could call alternative that is giant and old and big is the Drudge Report. And I noticed the White House is angry. The Drudge Report wouldn't take down their link that Obama was in Afghanistan and said, no, he's not. And then, of course, he was. And they're freaking out over something they don't control there. They don't control Infowars.com. They don't control PrisonPlanet.com. And they don't fully control News Corp. And I told you, remember last year those memos came out from Media Matters, George Soros funded? White House gives them, you know, meetings every week saying we're going to infiltrate and destroy alternative media. And Fox was at the top. But guess who else is in there? Guess who else they attack? Me. Because I'm pro-gun, pro-family, anti-abortion, anti-globalist. I mean, we now have the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation responding to us. You think that makes me happy? Well, in a way it does, that we're having an effect, but it also is super creepy. We're in danger, folks. This is a real fight. And if they can take over News Corp, you better believe Infowars.com and the Drudge Report, DrudgeReport.com, and Limbaugh, and Michael Savage, and everything else. And then they're going to shut down all the leftist things they don't control. They don't want anything that's not under globalist control. It's happening. And look, even if I disagree with somebody's free speech, if they were trying to shut down the Huffington Post, that's AOL, if Republicans were in office and saying, let's shut down the Huffington Post because of their lies or they're unethical or whatever, I would defend the Huffington Post and even AOL. Look, last year, Homeland Security, and I'm barred from giving everything out because I'm told things in confidence, but then I'm like, oh, and I'm not allowed to tell people what happened. I mean, I could tell what Ventura's told on air and what Michael Braverman, a big, you know, producer for TV, he's got a couple hit shows right now. I can say what they said. That Homeland Security, members of Congress called and threatened Time Warner to ban that show, and they did. But the other stuff is just incredible. Incredible. And I cannot tell you. So let me explain something, ladies and gentlemen. Well, I live in the real world. That's why Breitbart drops dead the day he's supposed to release all this powerful stuff. And I said, watch, in 2 or 3 weeks, if they've been compromised or something's happened, if people have been threatened over there, they're going to release some milquetoast thing, and they did. And it did not match what he'd said and how this would destroy Obama. Now, maybe he died of a heart attack. I'm sad he's dead, but I hope he actually died of a heart attack. But you know what? My gut tells me he didn't. And now one of the coroners is dead. Poisoned. So, again, how do you have a Justice Department that's shipping hand grenades and guns into Mexico to demonize our rights? How do you have them going after News Corp? And the answer is they can't. That's like, I'm for the death penalty, but you can't have it because these states and the feds have been caught framing people. See what I'm saying? We'll be right back. Stay with us. I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. Products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just three of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
HempUSA.org has a revolutionary wonder food for detoxing the body and rebuilding the immune system.
Microplant powder can help unclog arteries and soften heart valves while removing heavy metals, virus, fungus, bacteria, and parasites. Plus, it cleans and purifies the blood, lungs, stomach, and colon. Keep your body clean with microplant powder. Visit us at HempUSA.org or call 908-691-2608 today.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Attention, information in this one-minute message could save your life. Don't wait for the next emergency to happen. Act now to be prepared. Now, more than ever, civilians and communities must communicate with family, friends, and neighbors in the event of civil unrest, natural disasters, or other emergencies. That's why there's CivilDispatch.com. CivilDispatch.com is a universal system that can be used for a wide array of urgent notification alerts. Weather emergencies, civil unrest, emergency responders, amber alerts, school or business closings, any need-to-know situation. CivilDispatch.com is an emergency dispatch communication system, allowing anyone to quickly and easily send and instantaneously track emergency email and text alert notifications. CivilDispatch.com gives you the power of enterprise alerting without the enterprise cost. Don't find yourself unprepared. Learn more and become a member at CivilDispatch.com. That's CivilDispatch.com. Civilian Emergency Dispatch System. Peace through preparedness.
In an emergency situation, would you drink contaminated water? You could if you had the amazing Life Straw from MyPatriotSupply.com. Life Straw is the most advanced personal water filter available today. It filters contaminated water from almost any source. Life Straw is lightweight and compact, perfect for hiking, camping, or in an emergency like a flood. Life Straw is easy to clean, comes with a one-year warranty, and has been used worldwide since 2005. Get the amazing Life Straw personal water filter at MyPatriotSupply.com. Plus, check out Survival Seed Vault, 20 seed varieties for only $37.95, Tattler canning lids, long-term storable foods as low as $69.95, and much more at MyPatriotSupply.com. Enjoy stress-free shipping on all orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927 or visit MyPatriotSupply.com. That's 866-229-0927, MyPatriotSupply.com. For emergency preparedness, self-reliance, and food independence.
I think I'm going to call Watson up, or maybe get Curtin. I'm going to do an article about the insane hypocrisy of a criminal, executive, judicial, legislative tyranny who exempts itself extrajudicially from law, saying they're going to try to shut down News Corp and talking about arresting Rupert Murdoch and his son and all these people. And I told you that's where all this is headed. And if people cower and give in to this, and people say, oh, good. You know, I'd love to see News Corp shut down. I'd love to see people like Rush Limbaugh off the air. Ladies and gentlemen, when you get governmental collusion with attack dog groups trying to shut people down, do you understand if they can shut down any media, they can shut us all down? We hang together or hang separate. You know, back when I defended Rush Limbaugh, making the point that this woman wants people to pay for thousands of dollars of condoms a year, why doesn't she pay for that herself? And then they made this big deal out of it. I mean, it's a ridiculous spectacle, a woman in Congress asking somebody to buy thousands of dollars of condoms for them. I don't want to pay for that, and I shouldn't have to. I'm sick of paying for everything. And they make this huge hissy fit out of it. And then I did a show about it. We posted the video of the radio show. And a lot of the commenters on Infowars.com were like, oh, I hate Limbaugh. I hope he dies. I hope he goes and takes some Oxycontin. I hope he loses his show. Don't you understand that they are bringing in SOPA? They're bringing in that system through the new bill, CISPA, that they're openly saying they want to censor everybody? And that if they get away with this, none of us are safe. I don't like a lot of the things Rush Limbaugh does. I don't like him running defense for the Republican establishment. I don't even really listen to Rush Limbaugh. But I recognize that the system wants to set the precedent to shut down what they see as libertarian, conservative, constitutional opposition. And that's how the establishment sees me. I see myself as just somebody who wants freedom. And I judge an issue by an issue-by-issue base, and try to get away from labels. But I've still got to communicate with people through the labels they know. So it's kind of a catch-22. You've got to use the labels people know and then define them in a way that you think more explains in a deeper definition or depth what's happening. But it's so common sense for me. It's so common sense that if the government was trying to shut down MSNBC, of course it wouldn't shut itself down, that's a pure government operation, that I would be, wow, this is a dangerous precedent. Even because something like that might be staged where they go along with being shut down just to set the precedent. You see what I'm saying? This is dangerous, 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 dangerous stuff we're talking about here. And so you've got the old dinosaur media who's always still had the instinct to defend free speech because journalists are taught that's what's important because it is, finally getting the idea that, oh, if they're going to survive, they won't come out and tell the truth on real issues that the people want to hear and give people real investigative reporting. No, they'll just merge with the big corporations and the government who are threatened by real media and call for a new dark age, an electronic Berlin Wall of regulation and fairness doctrine crud, and copyright persecution without due process to shut down the internet as we know it. So make no mistake, the gelding, bare minimum, this is the harassment, the cornering, the political warfare of the Soros slash feud with Rupert Murdoch and Roger Ailes. This is a battle going on right now, and they're going to use this to decide the future of the rest of the media. So you better circle the wagons around free speech. I mean, I don't like the stuff the Ku Klux Klan says. As long as they're not calling for killing somebody, they got a right to say it. I don't like what the new Black Panther Party says about whites being the devil and all being racist. And it's when they start saying, kill people. Go out and kill Whitey, that's when they should be arrested. Of course, they weren't, because it turns out the Justice Department was infiltrated and actually leading the protest and trying to get violence going. No kidding. No, the same folks that ship guns into Mexico to try to create total anarchy down there to then blame the Second Amendment, which they still did. Again, you got to wrap your mind around the fact we've got a real criminal government at the top. And we better, as a country, people across the board, government, out of government, media, you name it, say, hey, you know what? This is out of control. Back off. Stop it right there. The preservation of this republic, common sense, is on the line right now. And people better stand up for liberty and better be thinking about just how much danger we're in. Okay, I'm going to cover a bunch of news. Go to your phone calls when we come back. Stay with us.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for survivalseedbank.com.
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions, yet many are unaware of the entire function of the Silver Lungs system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs generator. Not only does the Silver Lungs system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lungs system at www.silverlungs.com to learn more about how the Silver Lungs system works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Right now, the average family spends one-fourth of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
Are you awake yet out there? Are you aware of just how serious history is and that it's repeating itself right now? All these people are into zombie movies and stuff like that. Not me. I've studied history and I know what real carnage and real death is, just from afar. And I don't want to see it visited upon us. Now, we're going to take some calls coming up here in a few minutes on any of the issues I've mentioned or anything you want to raise. But then we're going to clear the phones out in the second hour so we can talk to Steve Pachinik, Dr. Pachinik, who's been at the forefront of forecasting and then breaking down the bin Laden killing hoax we just celebrated on International Communist Day yesterday. Our great dear leader, Osama bin Bernanke's minion, Obama. So that is coming up. Here is some of the news at Infowars.com. The toll-free number to join us, of course, is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. Tennessee man arrested and imprisoned for using cash. Another headline, treasure hunter fears assassination over search for bin Laden's body. Do you fear assassination for the search for, say, Keebler elves? Obama Homeland Security official scolded for socialist tweet. From Communism Day to Government Loyalty Day, Obama says we must swear our loyalty to him. Tech giant warns CISPA is an alarming threat to privacy. So we're finally seeing some of the tech giants come out against it as they are starting to understand that there's a public is waking up to it. The denial of Cass Sunstein, just admit what you have written. He's now denying or saying he doesn't remember writing all these public papers calling for restricting and free speech and fining or basically, he says, make it illegal to criticize the government and to say the government's lying. Amazing. So we're going to be breaking that down. Also, Hugo Chavez and officials caught in huge drug money laundering scandal. Our own Max Cabrera is from, one of our great IT guys, is from Venezuela. And he tells the horror stories of living under Chavez. And so he wanted to do this report. And I see these idiots and they're going, you must work for the system because you don't like Chavez. Just because our system's corrupt doesn't then mean something else is good. See, it's this idea of Iran's good and we're bad, or we're good and Iran's bad. No, there's bad, corrupt people in charge everywhere. That's history. That's the problem. That's why liberty is that rare jewel that Thomas Jefferson talked about. Speaking of the cash issue, let me just cover this now. Tennessee man arrested and imprisoned for using cash. It was an older $50 bill. They arrested him and kept him in jail. And then finally, the evidence area said, I think this is real money. And they released him but said, you better go cash this in at the bank for something new. So he's bad. And I see articles routinely where people just show, well, I had a friend, Chris Athanas. I haven't talked to him in years. I think he still lives in Austin. Software engineer, you know, well-to-do, middle-class guy, a patriot. Knew him down at Access TV. And he went to prison for years. He was down on the edge of UT, and he was talking about silver. This is like 6-7 years ago. And he showed it to some people, and they called the police on him, thinking it was illegal to have a silver coin. And then it turned out he wasn't even on the UT campus, but they came off the campus saying, well, there's a buffer, and he had his concealed carry. And so they came, they got him for the silver, tried to charge him for that, and ended up trumping up stuff for being near a college campus with a firearm. No criminal record, software engineer, part of the community, developing all sorts of, you know, software that's well-known out there. And that's the American dream now. But I see these cases where, one case I remember was a few years ago, a guy goes into Best Buy, and he had, I think he was buying film, or a memory stick or something. You can pull up the article. Guys, type man arrested for using $2 bill at Best Buy. And then we can pull up the original info. It's like 5-6 years ago, so I forget the details. But all I remember about it was is that he had done something with Cub Scouts where he was teaching about the Declaration of Independence, because that's on the back of a $2 bill. It's a beautiful engraving. I know because I went to the U.S. Mint once when I was a kid in D.C., and I bought a whole sheet. In fact, it's somewhere around here. I need to get it framed. And it came in a red tube of $2 bills that they were selling as one sheet uncut. And I guess I can get arrested for that. I bought it at the U.S. Mint. But, see, I digress in these stories. And he had been teaching the Cub Scouts about it, and he was showing it to them, if memory serves, and then he had some left. He'd been handing them out, teaching them about the Declaration of Independence. So he went in to buy something at Best Buy, and they said, this is illegal. This isn't real. And the managers and all of them were so stupid. I would have just walked out, but the security guard blocked him, that they thought it was illegal, and the cops were so ignorant. That's what's so dangerous about the public's not even so much evil. They're just dumb, ignorant morons. Not just the police, the general public are just dangerously stupid. And he went to jail. He went to jail. In fact, you guys found the article. We put it up. Man arrested, cuffed after using $2 bills. Best Buy customer on being jailed. At this point, I'm a mass murderer. And let me see if I was right about the Cub Scouts. Let's see how good my memory is. That is from, what year is that from? 2005. So see, I said 6 years ago. It's actually like 7. see if I'm right about the Cub Scout thing. I know it was some youth deal about the Declaration of Independence. But the point is that this is what America is, where they're just constantly looking for something. I see articles where parents get arrested because their child gets a sunburn. I mean, then everybody's parents would have been arrested when I was growing up. It's just any excuse to throw the book at the public, but then meanwhile, the Justice Department can ship guns into Mexico. Okay, so there's that article, Infowars.com, Tennessee man arrested and in prison for using cash. Read the whole story. It is crazy. There's another story, Victims of Communism Day. And communists have killed almost 200 million people in the last 100 years. This is not, that's non-military deaths. This is a very dangerous group. You know, when I see a swastika, I feel threatened by it and know it's a symbol of a lot of death under its belt. But nothing like communist. And it's they got all these restaurants in town with communist signs out front. All the trendies go there, and they've got Mao restaurants everywhere. And you see all these yuppies that are into communism. Are you into getting put in a collectivist barn and working like a slave? And having people in black uniforms rape your wife if they feel like it? I mean, you people are just begging to be enslaved. So we've got that. Let me just run through some more and I'm going to your calls. I'll get into the whole bin Laden thing next hour. In the third hour, I'm going to play the amazing video Luke Radowski got. Obama information czar confronted over banned conspiracy theories paper. And he sits there and plays stupid and says, I don't remember writing that, even though it's been a huge national controversy. They've talked about he may not be able to be Supreme Court Justice. You know, Obama says he's going to probably nominate him at the next vacancy. And he just says, I don't remember that. So incredible footage and audio of that coming up. There's this story I saw yesterday and didn't cover, and I meant to get one of my writers to write on it more. But WorldNet Daily, of course, picked it up. It's the Pilot newspaper out of Norfolk, Virginia. And they don't even say to the second page that it was black-on-white crime. A beating at church in Brambleton. And the story is, for 2 weeks, the paper refused to report on whites in their cars being attacked by hundreds of young black people. And this is happening all over the country. It's epidemic. And the police, when they complained and went for help, were told, shut up and get back in your car. We're not going to help you. What do you want us to do? And the paper agonized over even reporting on this happening. Now, again, my issue is this is very dangerous. The globalists want to foster this so it boils up and gets really big. The Justice Department tried to cause race wars, as you know. NBC edited the tape of Trayvon Martin, regardless of whatever you think, if he was right or wrong, towards Zimmerman. The point is, the Justice Department had fomenters in there. The media tried to push this to get us fighting with each other. And now the media feels like they can report on it because the youths are bragging on Facebook about it. And some are saying, you know, it's not very nice to beat up white people, you know, some black folks. And they're saying, oh, yeah, well, they deserve it because of Trayvon. And so what's going to happen is the average yuppie that's self-loathing and everything is now going to start not being racist, but fearing all black people. And this will not be good for black folks socioeconomically. It won't be good for anybody. But that's what the globalists want. They want to keep you on their poverty pimp reservations, and they want, through the culture, the hip-hop, all of it, to sell that it's cool to talk bad about white people. And young punk white kids may get intimidated by that and go grovel at the feet of it. But most people go, well, I mean, I don't hate somebody because of the color of their skin, but wow, I better look out. And this is socio-economic divide and conquer going on. And it goes on, many blacks beat white couple, media bury attack. The outrage in Norfolk, Virginia today after a white couple was attacked by dozens of black teenagers, and the local newspaper did not report on the incident for 2 weeks despite the victims being reporters for the paper. Oh, yeah, I forgot that. These are reporters at the paper. and the only reason it is being reported now is because they are reporters down the road and the people that did it bragged about it. But it's happening all the time now, reportedly, there in that town alone and all over the country at fairs and other events. And it's like, oh, there's some white people. They deserve to be beat up and robbed. You know what? It's a good thing that it wasn't somebody like me. And, of course, it always happens in little enclaves of yuppiedom. I guess that's what, I mean, ladies and gentlemen, If you attack, say, one or two cars, it's about a 50-50 chance that it's people are packing and they go to the shooting range every week. And they're going to, and then it'll be another race war. Because if you're being attacked and beat up and you shoot somebody, oh my gosh, another devil whitey did this. And then whites get paranoid. And then some innocent people are going to get killed. I mean, I'm not looking forward to a race war. The feds are really trying to start one. So they can come in and attack the Second Amendment, just like they ship guns into Mexico to create total bedlam and thousands of dead down there and hundreds of dead here, including six law enforcement officers, conservatively. Three police, three border patrol. You better believe there's not big parades for them. It's kept down low when cops get killed by the Fed guns. So it just goes over all of it. Yeah, I forgot that little part about how they were reporters for the paper. Okay, we've got our own article on that at Infowars.com as well. Again, this is in The Hill. Ethics watchdog asks FCC to revoke Fox broadcasting license. Okay, how can the government revoke somebody's license? I don't like that. Can we revoke somebody's license for shipping guns into Mexico? We're giving Solandra $500 million, they never built anything? Can we get a watchdog on Obama shutting down power plants not owned by GE to increase their profits? Can I get a watchdog on all the terrorists Obama was financed by in Chicago and the Chicago Mafia? Oh, I'm sorry, the Justice Department's part of that. DHS again to release bacteria in Boston subway. They say it's safe, but we've looked into it. It's been known to cause spontaneous abortions in mammal species. I know that from the last time we caught him doing it over Oklahoma. Paul doesn't have that in his article. Something else fell through the cracks I need to tell him about. And we got a bunch of other news. It's all coming up. In the second and third hour. Let's go to your calls so we get to some of those. Brad, Aaron, Stephen, Tom, Roy, and others. Brad in Idaho, you're on the air. Welcome.
Hey, longtime listener and disseminator of your work, and I really appreciate you. Me and my kids pray for you every day and your crew. My question to you is concerning something. So it's a pure of heart question. It seems to me like what would Abraham Lincoln have done? Should he just have left the South secede from the Union? And the question also would be like Hugo Chavez. Should he? It seems like a hard war to deal with that these guys are in.
Well, I mean, Hugo Chavez is power grabbing, giving people's businesses to his buddies. I mean, it's on record. I mean, like 5-6 years ago, he was saying no to the Pan-American Union. I'm like, oh, well, that's good. But he's definitely gotten worse and worse. That's what happens when somebody stays in and basically gerrymanders things and manipulates things to stay in power. As for the Civil War, that is an incredibly complex question. The British were manipulating the South, but using real grievances of the North that had written the tariffs to hurt the agrarian South, not the industrial North. But then the British put troops in Canada. They tried to menace both sides. So that's a very complex issue. All I know is Abraham Lincoln said over and over again that it wasn't about slavery. He did that at near the end of the war. It was all about tariffs and Western expansion. And the British did want to break up the Union. So it's a complex issue from many different sides. His cardinal sin was issuing U.S. money, not banker debt-backed money, but actual government fiat money to finance things. So I appreciate your call, and thank you for your prayers, my friend. Steve in Florida, you're on the air.
Hey, good afternoon, Alex. Hey, I wanted to say, first of all, you were mentioning earlier about how you're always, referring to the globalists and their agenda by referring to the Easter Bunny. You might want to change that to the what we call the truth fairy, because that's what they're putting forth, a fairy tale that they're calling the truth, but it really isn't.
No, I hear you. My point is, I was just saying, they killed bin Laden and threw him in the ocean. Might as well be the Loch Ness Monster, the Easter Bunny. I mean, it's that stupid. And then we're like, you're known liars, but I'm supposed to just believe whatever you say. I mean, it just suspends logic to just mindlessly go along with it. And then they just call you a conspiracy theorist if you don't trust people. I mean, take all the thousands of chemical and biological and radiological tests that have killed U.S. servicemen and others that this so-called government's done. just to test and see if they could get government scientists and doctors to do it. Now they want to release a bacteria they say is safe in the Boston subway. And we're like, how do we even know that's the bacteria? I mean, again, these are bad people. Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, well, along those lines, you know, about people believing lies, I was talking to a neighbor the other day here, and, you know, we were talking about the whole situation of what's going on with America and the direction it's going. And anyway, I got into mentioning about 9/11 being an inside job, and, of course, she automatically labeled me as a nutcase and said, you know, of course, she listens to Rush Limbaugh every day. And I said, oh, you mean the poster child for the neocons that puts forth all this propaganda because he's paid so much? I said, you know, I mentioned Alex Jones and InfoWars.com. No, I'm not going to listen to him if you want. I said, why? Have you ever, you know, listened to him or checked out any of his
documents? Just stay there. I want to hear how this story ends. And then more calls. And then we're going to unravel the story of Osama bin Laden and the ridiculous fairy tale.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure, but if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Mother's Day is next week, and Pro Flowers is offering an amazing deal. One dozen assorted roses plus a free glass vase for just $19.99. Go to ProFlowers.com, click on the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter the secret code 7777. But hurry, this incredible deal expires this Friday. Flower prices will skyrocket next week. Order now from Pro Flowers to get huge savings. You pick the delivery date, and it's guaranteed. That's one dozen stunning assorted roses, absolutely bursting with color, sent fresh from the fields, and guaranteed to stay fresh and beautiful for at least 7 full days for only $19.99, plus a free glass vase with every order. Remember, flower prices can double, even triple next week, and this incredible special expires this Friday. The only way to get this amazing deal is to go to proflowers.com, click on the radio microphone in the upper right corner, and enter the secret code 7777.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
In 1814.
In 1814, we took a little trip along with Colonel Jackson down the mighty Mississippi. We took a little bacon and we took a little beans, and we caught the bloody British in a town in New Orleans.
Okay, let's go back to your calls. During the break, I was talking to John Bowen in there, and he said, it is crazy that we lie to our kids. We're taught, tell them Santa Claus, the Tooth Fairy, the Easter Bunny. All of this is real. And then people sit there and lie to their children. People will get mad if you tell your children Santa Claus isn't real, and then they tell other children. I've had parents say, come on, don't tell your kids that. They're telling... You know, friends, that Santa Claus isn't real. And I'm just like, I'm not lying to my children and telling them that Santa Claus is real. I mean, I'm not doing it when they were really little. And I just can't believe, and I'm a conspiracy theorist because I don't believe in Santa Claus. And that's really what this comes down to. I don't believe in the bin Laden thing. In fact, I know it's a fraud and a hoax, and I told you it would happen years before. And it's simple. Known certified liars have to be removed. This entire government at the top is as rotten as a dead dog in the ditch. A dead dog's been dead for a week and a half. I mean, this thing is crawling with maggots. And it stinks, and it looks like every other tyranny we've ever seen, with an icing of high tech, which makes it even more dangerous. And there's a bunch of people out there saying, oh, I don't want to hear that, Alex Jones. Well, listen, folks, if you think the mainline Republicans and the mainline Democrats are going to give you anything else than what you've always seen, and if you don't think it's, and don't worry, it's not going to be business as usual, it's going to get a whole lot worse, a whole lot quicker. Going back to Steve in Florida, so you're talking to this lady, and she, we had ended with, I'm not going to listen to Alex Jones. Go ahead.
Yeah, and of course, you know, I got into about, you know, the election and Ron Paul, and see, this was just, this is a classic case of someone who's been subjected to the New World Order psychological programming and manipulation, doesn't even realize it, through their media outpost. You know, I talked about Ron Paul. Oh, he's a nutcase. You know, you're going to be wasting your vote. He can't get elected. All the typical stuff that's been put out
there.
No,
they repeat what they've been programmed with, and it's like a baby with a blanket. They think they're smart because they repeat talking points. And, of course, now it's admitted he won those first states, but they just said he didn't to create the idea he couldn't win. I mean, they let the government media force-feed them.
And so when I brought up about 9/11, you know, I said, okay, so I brought up the TSA and how they're rolling them out and putting them at checkpoints and then, you know, all these other places. And I said to her, okay, if you want to live in that fantasy world and believe what you're being told, that's a bunch of lies. When it comes to your door, don't say you weren't warned. Oh, that's not going to come to my door. I said, boy, you're in for a rude awakening.
It's already coming with the shots and the fluoride and the GMO. That's how they like to kill these people, is real quiet so they don't know who did it. But look, here's a headline out of USA Today. Obama in Afghanistan, Al-Qaeda defeated hand. See, it's the new talking point. The war on terror is over, but the TSA's on the streets and going to grope you. You're now the terrorist. I told you, the branding's here. So ask him. Al-Qaeda's put in Libya and all these other countries. The government now says they're good guys. What's all this homeland security for?
Well, you see, but somebody like her, her whole response, that's just Obama and the liberals. It's got nothing to do with the previous administration.
Exactly. You know? And as soon, and there's been total continuity of agenda. Total continuity of agenda. Bush came out for the power plant shutdowns under carbon taxes. Bush was for the assault weapons ban. Of course he was. Why is Mitt Romney identical to Obama in his actions as governor? Because the same people that bought and paid for Obama have bought and paid for Mitt Romney. It's just that he'll be a lighter form of it and will actually get more through on us. Heaven help us.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at Infowars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. Infowars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at Infowars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, Steve Pachinik, who 9 years ago on my radio show exposed the death of bin Laden and that he would be rolled out in a later date. He's going to be joining us to take your phone calls for military callers, but let's continue with calls right now quickly. Roy in Montana, then we're going to Tom. Roy, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, just the first-time caller, and, you know, I found you on the Internet, and what I wanted to call and tell you is my son is a force recon sniper, and he was just got out of his deployment in Afghanistan, and now he said they're having him fill out all the deployment paperwork again. And I asked him, I said, why are they doing that? Are you going back? He said, no, they're going to deploy us into Syria on the Turkey border. Well, the media says that, you know, Turkey won't allow us to go on the border or whatever, but he said his company is the first.
No, that's already going on. They're on the Jordanian side, too. It's admitted that U.S. troops are surrounding and funding the peaceful al-Qaeda. And again, I'm not saying Assad's good, but I got to have TSA stick their hands down my pants because of al-Qaeda. But al-Qaeda works with NATO. I mean, come on.
Yeah. And another thing I was wondering, you probably already know about this, but the Freedom Group that's been buying up these gun manufacturers like Bushmaster, Marlin, Remington, DPS, they're owned by Service, I can't pronounce it, Capital Management, who is run by George Soros. They bought up like 6 gun manufacturers so far.
Yeah, that was even in the New York Times a few months ago. Very, very scary. And that's why you see so much anti-gun stuff from the big manufacturers not defending themselves. That's why it's important to buy from the smaller and mediums that are being harassed by the globalists to make sure that we... Because you've got to vote with your dollars. And the system's coming after the Second Amendment. What did Obama promise Sarah Brady last year? It's on record in the Washington Times. He said, don't worry, I'm going to get their guns under the radar. I mean, these are terrorists. I'm going to say that again. Criminal terrorist. I'll tell you, he has courage. You got to agree with him. I've said it before he said it, and I know he's a listener. We've had him on. But Ted Nugent, when he says these are criminals, these are anti-American criminals. They have been caught doing this. Anything else, sir?
Yeah, one quick thing. I have a new name for you for the media. The mainstream disinfo propaganda machine. My 14-year-old son kind of had a funny story this morning. He came up with a little, there was a woman standing at the door during Halloween, and there was a pirate, a ghost, and a little kid standing in a suit. And she said, oh, I can see you're a pirate, and I can see you're a ghost, but what are you? The little kid in the suit looks up and says, I'm the government. I'm the biggest monster of all.
Well said. It is the greatest monster. God bless you, sir. Say hi to your son for me. Good joke. Tom in Georgia, you're on the air.
Hey, Alex, I'm calling from FEMA Region 4. Two quick points that I'd like you to look into, piggybacking on one of the stories you did a couple weeks ago. I have a cousin who's married to a soldier stationed out at Stewart, Brigade Homeland, who told her that the guys that blew up that fella's house in Roswell, they were wearing Fulton County Marshal's uniforms, which is why your Roswell police, all those guys were off duty that day, but that they were actually soldiers from Stewart that did it. You look into that. Number two, the former Viper squads that have been hanging out on Interstate 40 as you go into Memphis in the little cutoff there where it goes down from 70 to 55 have moved eastward, and now on all of their vehicles it says District 23 Police. So I stopped and asked a guy at the rest area, hey, where's the 23rd District in Tennessee? And he said, man, I don't know what that is. There's no such thing. Those are TSA guys on the interstates in Tennessee on Interstate
40. No. Stay there. Exactly. It's like in Romancing the Stone where Colonel Zulu or whatever It puts new patches on every 5 minutes. I got Pachenik coming up, but I want to talk about troops because, stay there, this is big.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it. Others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it. Others don't.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
Right now, the average family spends one-fourth of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
All right, we're going to Steve Pachenik, Dr. Pachenik here in just a moment with breaking analysis, how it ties into Obama's visit to Afghanistan and a lot more. We're going to be taking military phone calls. I'm going to give that number out, but let me just stop right there. We just got a caller, Tom in Georgia, and I want him to recap what he said. A few weeks ago, a Mr. Words was killed in a town outside of Atlanta, a pretty big town, Roswell. We sent our film crew there. The house was basically blown up and burned out. They wanted the land for an environmental biosphere. They'd already taken a bunch of other land. He'd been legally having a few dozen chickens for a long time on his acreage. They kept citing him. He kept winning. Then somebody poisoned his chickens. Then the house blew up. Our guys get there because there's been some discussion of foul play, and they won't say whether it was the police or the sheriff's department, but witnesses say it was younger men in sheriff's department outfits. They call them marshals there in that county. But the sheriff says on record, and I have the local papers, that he had no deputies involved. Now, this caller says he has a military source, and I want him to repeat this because it rings true with my information. We had the police basically threaten to arrest our crew. They said they couldn't tape the courthouse, the city building, the city hall, couldn't go in it. This is on video. Can't tape it threatening them like it's North Korea or something, Darren McBreen and Marcos Morales, acting very suspicious, saying we were all off duty that day. The entire police department says they're off duty. This is a big town. I mean, the city hall looks like a capital in many states. So all of this is going on. The big marble steps, whole nine yards. And then everybody says it's the sheriff's department, but they say no, they weren't there. Now, the caller said he talked to Brigade Homeland, and that's where it's based. They're at that fort. He's going to repeat it. That are going to operate domestically. You see a mass shooting, Marines are out armed. Marines at DWI checkpoints, Army. In the Army Times saying, yeah, we're going to pull triggers on Americans. That's a quote. We're going to expand out from 4,000. This is in 2008. In the next 5 years, here we are. You can pull up these quotes. And we're going to Dr. Pachenik, but this is breaking. We're going to expand out to 379,000 troops in America to deal with civil unrest. Now Obama has NDAA. Now he tells Congress he'll launch wars without approval. We're not in Kansas anymore. They're getting this country ready. I don't think they're going to get away with it because the military's waking up. The police, not so much. The military is. Now, that said, he calls in and says, yeah, the person I know at the base says, look into this, Alex. It was really troops from there. Folks, I've got in Road to Tyranny, Army and Marines, one Marine Corps captain. Later became a software engineer and, you know, lives in a mansion. Point is, he ran to an Army checkpoint and got mad and spoke to me in 2000. Showed me photos, all of it. He was a Marine. In 88, they would, in Norfolk, Virginia, they would raid gun dealers' homes with Marines in police outfits. This is a long-term program now confirmed. Totally illegal. And my gut told me send reporters there. And I, from this information, we need to check into it. We need FOIAs, all of it. I'm putting attention on this. It could, folks, there's a very good chance that, again, they're trying to test and seek, and they get, when people are dug in their houses, have the military kill them. Just like they use Delta Force at Waco and to blow up the church records vault in there with a shape charge. General Parton, former head of Air Force Weapons Development, broke that down. I'm going to go to Dr. Pachenik. I apologize for him having to hold, but this is breaking news. So we'll hold him a little bit in the next hour to catch up on time to take military calls as well. But, sir, repeat everything you just said on air, because some stations don't carry that first 5 minutes. Who this person is, the fort, where Brigade Homeland is based, everything you said like tumblers just clicked. As that I believe you, but we've got to ferret this now. This is chilling. The police act like they are scared to death there in that town. So does the sheriff. Go ahead.
Absolutely, Alex. I have a relative who's married to a soldier stationed at Stewart in the Brigade Homeland. Now, this is why I was saying I wanted you to check into it. There's a lot of soldiers there that want to have an outlet to talk about this. Their training, and another story that you were telling about the DNR up in Michigan, coincides with what's going on. They're taking these guys from Fort Stewart all over the country, because you think about it. People in DNR in Michigan, they're the neighbors of these guys, these pig farms they're raiding. What they're training the guys at Stewart.
No. I know what they're, exactly. It is the governor's council and the rural council that is the Pentagon. It's military occupation with local cadres of goons. This is hellish. This is Red Dawn in slow motion. It's happening. I can't believe it.
But what they're training the guys at Stewart to do in their day-to-day training is wear police uniforms of these different parts of the country, like Fulton County Marshals. They're training in these local uniforms, and the soldiers are like, why are we doing this? You know, you have a lot of dissent within the ranks out there at Stewart. If you can get guys out there to interview them, you'll have, and I'm not just talking.
Sir, I'm already aware of it. I was already, when you mentioned this, this district, you know, 23 group and all that, Tennessee's the major testing ground, but now it's expanding. They have TSA in fake local made-up outfits now. I mean, this is directly out of the worst communist dictatorships. I mean, this is so hellish. This is where the secret police aren't just wearing masks, they're putting on different uniforms. I mean, this is so evil. So listen, yes, we'll have a show tomorrow, or an hour or so, where we have Fort Stewart troops call in. And quite frankly, that's a lead we already had. And the police were looking like they'd killed people when we bring this up. I mean, and the sheriff says he wasn't there and his people weren't. This is so evil. And they probably killed that guy. Anything else? I mean, are they saying the military killed him, or are they just saying they were there?
All of it, like I said, this is from the wife. I'm related to the wife of this soldier. they were deployed. He wasn't in the group that was deployed, but they deployed to that incident. They're deploying all over the country in local law enforcement uniforms. They're training in the uniforms at Stewart that they're going to deploy.
No. Let me stop you. The FBI, by accident, pulled up to us in 98 on the day after Thanksgiving, north of Austin, and said, okay, stop filming the military at this checkpoint, but here's the press release. It was not a press release. It said, do not destroy, or maybe the guy was a friend, but it was an FBI guy, gave Mike Hansen, my camera guy, the document that said, do not give to the public. This is restricted. We're here to respond 24 hours a day to warrant service, whatever you need, helicopters, anything. Yeah, no, it's very old program. They're just now getting ready to roll it out. God bless you. Thank you so much, sir. Dr. Pachinik, I want to compartmentalize this now. I want to come back from break and get into the bin Laden fable. I don't want to mix things here. And I want to tell folks who Dr. Pachinik is, but I want to get a few minutes from you. Okay, so he lost his phone. Okay, he's on a cell phone. It was dropping. But we're going to go back to Dr. Pachinik because I want to break this down with him. But I had to go to that because this is breaking and this is a big story. Hope you didn't get mad at being on hold for 5-6 minutes while I did that. But it had to happen. We have to cover this information. I mean, let me tell you, you know when people are acting suspicious, and they use military to kill the Davidians. It's like, well, they're a cult. They deserve it. See, that's how they do this, and now it's everywhere. And they're planning to use the military in local police uniforms to take out people. And this is so evil. It's so illegal. It's so off the charts. Now, let me do this now. I'm going to clear the phones out for military to call in about the bin Laden fable. But you'll have to hold a little bit while Pachinik breaks it down, and then we'll do that. But the toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. But I want to shift gears as we go to break here, and I want to play this video of Luke Radowski, Obama information czar, confronted over banned conspiracy theories paper. This is a big, big deal. Claims to have no memory of saying free speech should be taxed. But then we have the links in our article and in the video to where he wrote papers for the University of Chicago and also Harvard just in 2008 before he got in, as the regulations are, saying this. Do we have that tape? Okay, let's go ahead and roll that right now. Here it is.
My name is Bill DeBerg from Brooklyn College. And I know you wrote many articles, but I think the most telling one about you is the 2008 one called Conspiracy Theories, where you openly advocated government agents infiltrate activist groups of non-love and truth and also stifle dissent online. I was wondering, why do you think it's the government's job, or why do you think the government should go after family members who have questions about 9/11, responders who are lied to about the air, survivors whose testimony commits, and also government whistleblowers that were gagged because they released information that contradicts the official story? Why do you think the government should do that?
I think, as Ricky said, I've written hundreds of articles, and I remember some and not others. That one I don't remember very well. I hope I didn't say that. But whatever was said in that article, my role in government is to oversee federal rulemaking in a way that is wholly disconnected from the vast majority of my academic writing, including that. So
I know that I'm just asking because you may be the next Supreme Court Justice for Obama to appoint you, and you did write those things, and that's why I'm going to bring them up to you.
So and all I can say is there are a lot of things that I've written, I guess, and there are even more things I'm said to have written. I may agree with some of the things I've written, but I'm not exactly sure. I focus on what my boss wants me to do.
I just want to know, is it safe to say that you retract saying that conspiracy theorists should be banned or taxed for having an opinion online? Is it safe to say that?
I don't remember the article very well, yeah. So. Uh, I hope I didn't say either of those things.
But you did, and it's written. Do you retract them?
I'm focused on my job.
So you're not retracting that. Do you still believe that? Do you still believe that there's people should have freedom of speech?
Thanks so much. Yeah, so, I'm happy to talk about this, by the way. I can go on the record.
He's the man who wrote about it. So Cass, do you still believe in the Joseph Goebbels approach?
Please don't.
I'm asking a question.
I know, but you're...
I'm asking a question.
Just, you know.
It's the job of a journalist to ask questions.
I'm going
to
give a book, sir.
Okay, go get your book, sir.
A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even though I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
Hi, I'm Mark Craighead, founder of Crossbreed Holsters. I designed our top-selling holster, the Super Tuck Deluxe, to solve the problems of being poked, pinched, and gouged while carrying concealed. The Super Tuck Deluxe is the most comfortable, most concealable holster on the market today. We offer a 2-week free trial and a lifetime warranty.
Visit us at crossbreedholsters.com. Don't forget, crossbreedholsters.com. That's crossbreedholsters.com.
In a coming-apart world, you need something to keep it tied together. That something is Atwood Rope, the highest quality rope made in the USA from exotic braids for military, rescue, arborists, shipyards, tow line, or boating. Quality rope at affordable prices you and your customers can depend on. Find a dealer or shop online at atwoodrope.net. Enter promo code RADIO to receive 100 feet of 550 paracord free with purchase. Atwood Rope, working to keep the world tied together.
We all know there are secrets behind closed doors in every relationship, and one of the biggest is that men are losing libido, or sexual desire, especially if you're a man over 40. The problem could be declining testosterone levels. Remember, it's testosterone that makes a man in every way. That's why they created T-Gen. It contains an all-natural ingredient that will safely boost your testosterone. You need healthy levels of testosterone to have a good mood and a positive, energetic mind. Call now and you'll receive a free bottle of T-Gen with your order. 1-800-577-8644. 1-800-577-8644. In a study of exercising men using the ingredient in T-Gen, 85% reported an improvement in sexual desire. So don't wait. Call now. Call 1-800-577-8644. That's 1-800-577-8644.
37 things to hoard. Do you have the 37 crucial food items you can't survive without? When the next disaster hits and the mobs go crazy grabbing food off the shelves, you and your family may be without food or waiting in long food lines. Prepare now at 123survivalplan.com. Easy as 123 to remember. 123survivalplan.com. Many people don't have these 37 food items. Learn what you need to hoard now at 123survivalplan.com. Watch the video we've set up for Patriots only at 123survivalplan.com. Get inside information on the 37 food items that will sell out first when the next disaster strikes. This video contains crucial information you and your family need to prepare for any natural or man-made disaster. In the last 6 months, over 1 million other smart patriots have already seen this video. Prepare now. Go to 123survivalplan.com and learn which 37 food items you should hoard. Easy to remember. 123survivalplan.com. Again, that's 123survivalplan.com.
By the way, we have a special guest tomorrow. I'm just going to leave it at that as a surprise, but a guest we've never had on the show before.
Ira Hayes. Ira Hayes.
Call him Drunken Ira.
The guys pop in my ear on the microphone, but they never talk loud enough for me to be able to hear what they're saying. It's just kind of like I hear the mic open up, and then I'm... By the way, Steve Buchanek, which is just classic, he is such a character. He's like, I don't want to talk about a chicken farmer. I'm here to talk about Bin Laden, so have me on another time. I'm like, okay. He's like, this is big stuff. But then it is big that they've got troops confirmed running around in police uniforms. I know that's true. And I know they send them to people's houses they see that are high threat to take out the enemy. That's the American people. And that is about as big a news as it gets. And so I went into a whole rant about that. But we'll try to get Steve Buchanek on tomorrow or the next day. And I, because I know Steve's listening. He's a great guy. He certainly is a character. And I wanted to get his breakdown on Bin Laden and take your calls on that subject. And I'm still going to do it. I want to hear from military who've been in Afghanistan. Do you buy the Bin Laden story? And do you like what Obama is doing with this story? The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. What did you think of part of the clip? The full video is up at Infowars.com. Obama informations are confronted over banned conspiracy theorist paper. He wrote this in 2008, wrote two of them. It's on record. He's talked about it before, but suddenly he's got amnesia. He won't retract it, but he won't say that he wrote it. That's part of the total disdain. That's like when one of the heads of the Hart-Rubin Commission, former Senator Gary Hart, gave speeches about it, but he also sent a letter to Ahmed Energy, I don't know, 5 years ago, and said, we'll stage terror attacks and blame it on you. Like the Gulf of Tonkin, the USS Maine, you better do what you're told. Don't think just because the American people aren't wanting to have war with you that we won't stage something. So We Are Change goes to one of his speeches, brings it up, says, your letter to Ahmed Energy of last year, this is years ago, it's in Truth Rising, the film I made, amazing video. You said this in this letter. And he goes, no, I didn't. I don't. They go, yeah, we have it right here. I don't remember that. So they start reading it to him, and he goes, oh, that letter. And he starts sweating and freaking out. It's like, you're not, and he publicly published this, but they're so used to the public not knowing how to tie their shoelaces, not knowing what country they're in, not knowing what government they're under. You're just having no idea about anything. That when you actually confront them, he's like, come on, Cass, here's your paper. You wrote it. You know about these papers. It's been an issue in the news. Should you be nominated to be the next Supreme Court justice when that vacancy comes up, you've absolutely got to respond to this. And Cass just smiles at him. It's like, listen, dog meat, I'm your God. I control reality. Remember the quote of Karl Rove? He's talking to the New York Times, Washington Post, and other reporters at the cocktail party. And they said, come on, you know there's no WMDs. You guys lied on purpose. And Rove goes, it doesn't matter. We control reality now. You will do what we say. I'll change it tomorrow. You'll be a good little doggy, and you'll, I'm paraphrasing it, go read it. And I'll change that reality, and you'll follow it. I'm history's actor. We're history's actors. We're an empire now. Says we're an empire now, and you will dutifully do what you are told. You will dutifully do what you are told. You will dutifully do it. And they said, yeah, I guess we will. And he's like, that's right. We pay you, don't we? Now, step and fetch it, slave. And that's they want their kids to live in a world like that where, you know what? We'll tell you today it's up. We'll tell you tomorrow it's down. We'll tell you it's left when it's right. We'll tell you that sewage is apple pie. And you will do what you're told. Or you're a conspiracy theorist, which means you don't get establishment approval. And they said, okay. In fact, it took a couple years for that quote to come out. And then there was a debate about whether he said it, and then other writers said, yeah, we were there, he said it. I mean, imagine the chief advisor of the president, on paper he wasn't, he was the assistant, but in reality he was, just going, you guys are nothing. You'll do whatever we tell you. We'll change something completely tomorrow and you'll believe it. We control reality. And you know what? When you get the public That's like O'Brien when he's torturing Winston in 1984. He says, you don't think our scientists can come up with mathematics to show that there is no gravity, but still have another set to have gravity to navigate ships and aircraft? You don't think we can't do that, Winston? We can, and we probably will. It's all about destroying reality, Winston. Now, I'm going to torture you some more, pal, till you get that straight to your little noggin. Because we control reality. And the general public's like, you bet. Karl Rove says jumping into a meat grinder is good for you. We'll do it. Because we like to be patted on the head by the mainstream media.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup, insurance, and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365. Hi folks, this is Alex Jones and I want to tell you about the Silver Lungs Generator. Now you can produce pure and endless colloidal silver and deliver the solution directly into the bloodstream by breathing the solution through the lungs. The respiratory system is the first line of defense for airborne pathogens and viruses. The Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced nano-silver solutions and also delivers the silver nanoparticles instantly into the bloodstream. With continued legislation threatening the sale of nano-silver products, you can now produce pure and endless colloidal silver with the Silver Lungs Generator. Very easy to follow, step-by-step instructions are provided, making production fast and simple. Go to www.silverlungs.com today and learn more about the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs Generator. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Okay, we've got our phones loaded with airborne people, wife of Navy folks, Coast Guard, military people chiming in. We're about to talk to on Obama or Barry Sotero or whatever his name is this week, whatever citizenship he is this week, Kenyan, Indonesian. He says, you know, he killed bin Laden and threw him in the ocean, and that they were watching and commanding live feeds of the SEALs. Turns out they said, well, that isn't true. And yeah, that's a fake photo, but everything else is true. Yeah, the helicopter blew up, and then the rest of the SEALs blew up. But the SEALs were going to save Rangers. Oh, but they weren't going to save Rangers. But Pat Tillman was charging Al-Qaeda. Oh, actually, we had him killed. Oh. But Jessica Lynch was saving people. Oh, that was fake, too. And people died once they got back to the U.S. because they wouldn't go along with it. They got killed, assassinated. Oh, there's nothing going on. Then people say, well, why are you still alive, Alex? Because I'm a public figure. And because if they kill me, it will make a big issue out of it. But they might. And I'll tell you, I'm not looking forward to that. But this is Obama's re-election strategy. And he said he wouldn't spike the football, wouldn't use it. When you heard that, you knew it was a lie. Because we're the enemy. He works for the bankers. He wants to socialize things so that we're dependent on them. And then once we're dependent on the system, they can totally control us. Okay, let's go to your phone calls. And after we go to this first round, I am just poleaxed by the man talking about the military at Fort Stewart, which is one of the main brigade homeland centers, and talking about military in plain clothes raiding the chicken farmer who got killed. Because it all fit into place. People say it was Sheriff's Department outfits, but the Sheriff's Department said none of our deputies were there. And the sheriff says, we didn't do that. And then all the police deputies or police officers were off that day and look totally freaked out. I mean, I've got articles here out of the Pilot newspaper, the official Virginia Pilot there in Norfolk, where their own reporters were racially attacked by 100 black youths, and others are being attacked, and the police will not respond, and the newspaper wouldn't let them report it until the youth began to brag on Facebook about it. So, I mean, the media, talk about control, political correctness. It's more than just political correctness. It's total, like, CIA-level black ops, because they won't even report on racial attacks all over Norfolk, Virginia. And they won't report on the military that I've confirmed is in plain clothes raiding people's houses for decades, and now it's expanding. So I want to hear from military that's been part of this. I've interviewed people. I've seen the documents. I've gotten documents where the FBI goes, okay, here's your press release, and it's not. It's a secret document. And the FBI guy jumps in his car and drives off. Was it an accident? Was it on purpose? That is in my film. Police State 2, the takeover. And those documents are online. And it says, this is restricted. Don't let the public see it. Fort Hood, will respond anywhere in Texas. We'll send helicopters, SWAT teams, warrant service. Within hours, you need us. The U.S. Army stands ready. They tell the public, oh, it's bomb disposal. No, it's not. That's the cover. And in another drill they did, I had the Army come up and say, turn your camera off. And I said, no, I'm not going to. And the guy started bowing up, and I said, do whatever you're going to do, man. This is what's happened in America. I mean, this is how far we've gotten. All right, I'm going to go to the military. We're going to go to Bob in Wisconsin, who was airborne in Afghanistan, then Aaron, a Minnesota National Guard, Stacy, Navy man's wife, has information. Patrick, Coast Guard in Texas. Steve, New Jersey, was an Army in Afghanistan. We'll go to all of you. And I'll try to shut up. This is just blowing me away. And it's not being reported. And you're like, well, how can that happen? They won't allow racial attacks to be reported all over the country. I mean, it's bad. Let's go to Bob in Wisconsin first. Bob, you're on the air.
Yeah, I was 3rd Brigade, 101st, 9/11. And, that morning, we watched it before I went to work. We never went back to work. And the funny thing they said to us that day was, pack your bags, we're going somewhere, we don't know where, and we don't know when. Well, we ended up over there. And our 1st Battalion and 2nd Battalion were in Anaconda. Well, I got there towards the end of Anaconda, right when they're coming out of the battle. Well, I ended up going to Coast at Chapman Airfield. There's only two platoons of us, and we were working directly for the Special Forces. And the big joke was, we're going to get Bin Laden. And a lot of the SF guys would sit there and right at you, and they'd go, are you kidding? oh, yeah, right, you know, but they won't say nothing. But mostly we played with, like, the Haqqani faction. You're looking at, like, a lot of warlords on the border right there. In the
sure, Colorado. And it's all a fight over opium.
Yep. I'm not... Now, you don't... As early as I was there, it was a chess match. You'd sit there and play chess with the day, go on patrol at night. Now, that's early, 10 years ago. Now, with 40,000 guys, there, you know, when I was there, there's 3,000 of us. Now, I watched everything go over that border, left and right, every day of the week, and there is no control in that. You know, I just sit here and grit my teeth 10 years later, and I agree. That's why I listen to you. It's a joke. I walked across the street. I saw bin Laden dead. I cried for the 10,000 guys that died over there because of it. You know, it ain't over.
Let me ask you a question. Do you believe any of this?
I believe when I came home going through the TSA was a joke. You know, but you got your Special Operations Command that ain't subject to that. You know. It's a horse. It's scary. There's no oversight. You know, I'd come
home.
Yeah,
so you come back after supposedly fighting Al-Qaeda and they want to grab your genitals. Meanwhile, it's on the news that Al-Qaeda openly is supposedly the good guys now in Libya and all these places. God bless you, sir. Good to hear from you. Let's go ahead and take another call here. Let's talk to Steve in New Jersey, who was in the Army in Afghanistan. What's your take on the one-year anniversary of him being killed and thrown in the ocean?
Alex, greetings to you. How are you?
Good.
You know, I don't even know where to start, to be honest with you. I mean, when you see how far we've degraded, you know, as a society, as America, as a principle, it really is just sad. You know, I think for me, I kind of... Having been home from Afghanistan, we started hearing the inklings that we were going somewhere, and it was Iraq. And I think after having been home, I didn't go to Iraq, but having been home and listening to the news stateside, and having been on the other side of the fence in Afghanistan, when these weapons of mass destruction didn't show up, I think that's when I woke up, and I really started to wake up at least. And, you know, with the whole Pat Tillman death and the Jesse Lynch, like you mentioned, it really opened my eyes to, man, this is really... politicize the war. I mean, I think it's sad, you know, when you know, it's funny, I often think of the lyrics from the Black Sabbath song, War Pigs, using people as pawns in chess. And I get angry. I get mad as hell. And it really, to think that I was essentially, myself and my comrades were used to forward these political agendas, which have absolutely nothing to do with
that. And by the time you figure it out, they've always got a new crop to breathe to you, to be given experimental shots, and to be tested on, and now to have the death benefits stolen. And in America, you're supposed to just put a flag out front of your house, bow down to the government, and that's patriotism. Well, if that's patriotism, I don't want any part of it. Talking to your buddies from the military, are any of them buying this bin Laden thing?
Well, it's funny. I have. I was an MP when I was in the Army, so you know, we tend to be the redheaded stepchildren of the Army. But so a buddy of mine decided, you know what, I want to go the Special Forces route. And you know, when bin Laden was killed, you know, he and I openly had this conversation. I said to him, "Look, you know, doesn't it seem a little fishy that this has been so nicely, you know." Gift wrapped and swept under a rug, so to speak. Well, you know, it does seem a little fishy, but the intel, you know, I have access to the SIPRNet, so the intel I read is different from what you guys read.
Yeah, but that's where the greatest propaganda is inside those secret news chains where they can get away with more ridiculous lies. It's like everybody I know in the military was the fake bin Laden photo. And then they say, oh, I saw a secret one. And I go, really, is this it? I go, that's a fake one. They never want to admit they got duped. The worst brainwashing is within those compartments. Because, see, when it has to go public, it can get debunked. When they keep it chambered, I mean, it's well known that the biggest brainwashing goes on inside the military.
You know, and because of the way that line of communication is secured, there's no way to tell whether it's true or not. You have to take it at face value and assume it's accurate.
Here's an example. One time I was at a land rights rally at the Capitol. No, it wasn't the Capitol. It was at the police station or down by the old city hall. The point is, I was walking back from my car and heard the police on their radios going, it's an extremist group. It's Republic of Texas. They're here trying to cause trouble. And we weren't Republic of Texas. They just made that up and just fed it to the cops to, like, you know, say these are bad guys. And I'm not saying Republic of Texas is bad. My point is that they just throw labels on. So just because it came down the radio, that doesn't mean, or just because you're in an internal group, that you're being given the truth, is my point.
I agree with you wholeheartedly. Now, unfortunately, I think a lot of these guys are still drinking the Kool-Aid, you know, in terms of, we're here for America and defending our freedom. And I think they're just naive to what's actually happening. You know, to me, the fact that his body was so neatly dumped over the side of a boat and, you know, is never going to be seen from again, it's fishy. I just don't get it. Like, to me, it's screaming that there's much more to it than what we're being told.
But what about him changing the story? There was no video feed. The Situation Room's photos fake. He didn't do a firefight. He didn't use his wife as a shield. The helicopter with the SEALs getting on it blew up. I appreciate your call. God bless you, sir. Let's go to, we've got Minnesota National Guard, infantry, army. Let's talk to Stacy, who's a Navy man's wife, with information. Stacy, what info do you have for us on the 1 year anniversary of the slaying of the dragon by Obama? I mean, the slaying of the goblin. I mean, the slaying of the devil. I mean, the slaying of the Easter bunny. I mean, bin Laden. What do you think about this?
Hi, Alex. Well, I can tell you one thing for sure. My husband recently returned from being deployed to Afghanistan. And no, he does not believe that we killed bin Laden over there in the raid. And, you know, he thinks the whole thing was just completely made up. And obviously we've been given no evidence whatsoever to prove it in any way, shape, or form. So no, he doesn't believe that. But there's something else I can tell you about that he experienced while he was on his deployment in Afghanistan. And that is the fact that the idea of 9/11 being an inside job was openly discussed amongst the troops while they were there, and that this happened with him, even with men of much, much lower rank, that, you know, I thought that really said something, that they were comfortable enough to talk about that with him in particular, to, you know, openly discuss that idea that 9/11 was an inside job. I thought that was a pretty good sign of, you know, where the military stands in terms of what the troops really believe and, you know, how our troops feel about this war.
And see, what they're doing is they're filtering out people that aren't smart or aren't sophisticated to be this brigade homeland. For years, they just filter them out, make them police, or keep them in domestic military formations for war with the people. Because the vast majority of the military, I mean, I've never really done this in the last few years because I've always seen it as a threat because it's under globalist control, but more and more, the statistics show it, the numbers, what I see, the military is more awake than any other group across the board.
There's one other thing I can tell you also, and this just happened in the last week or so. We actually have a couple of battalions at our base that are being redeployed that just got back. And so this is quite a shock, obviously, to these guys because they just recently got home. And they've been given almost no notice. This is a very unusual thing. So, you know, I don't know what what it was Obama said about, oh, he's supposed to be pulling troops out of Afghanistan, when apparently they're turning right around and sending a couple of battalions back out.
Well, that's a black op military tactic. You're charging the Davidian compound, ramming it with tanks, machine gunning. You say, come out, we're not firing, come out with your hands up. You're going to sign the NDAA? You say you're not. You're going to sign CISPA? You say you're not. You say you won't use the killing of bin Laden as a spike the football campaign a year ago? Of course he's using it. They lie even when the truth serves because you need to be fed a diet of lies. It is a system in psychological warfare they talk about of creating an entire false reality, a fog of lies, until people finally just disengage. So of course they're sending more troops in while saying they're pulling them out. Because I'll tell you, the globalists just want to sit on top that $500 billion a year in opium. and menace and make everybody angry at us and demonize America and chew up our troops and no-bid contracts. And so the Afghans want that smack money. This is a fight over drugs, just like in Mexico. And it's not about politics, religion, any of it. They want the goods. They want the money. And so the United States is starting to lose. See, the so-called U.S. wanted to sit in Southeast Asia and get all the smack money again. Back then, 90% was produced there, not in Afghanistan. So they just moved there. And they got finally run out over the goody, you know, goody gumdrop stuff, because the troops figured out this was about opium. It was about heroin. Well, now it's the same thing there. And so the war is being lost, and the drug-dealing bankers are like, my gosh, should we start a bigger war with Pakistan? We want our drug money. You know, we're not going to just have this crop delivered to somebody else or let the Pakistanis or the Ruskies have it. I mean, is your husband concerned about all the opium being grown?
Well, I mean, he's aware of it, obviously. In his particular job while he was over there, he didn't get to witness that much of that type of activity going on, but he was aware of it. But yeah, I mean, the reasons why we're there are not the reasons why we're there.
Well, I mean, from every analyst I've seen, the globalists using our military are starting to lose the war. I mean, is that what your husband's telling you?
Oh yeah, it's you know, he believes we shouldn't be there at all, and it's you know, we should have gone in the first place, and it's long been past time to go.
Yeah, and look, all the propaganda in the world's not going to stop those Taliban from wanting their heroin money. And so, just like Alexander the Great and everybody else, the United States will be thrown out of Afghanistan.
I'd seen the longevity products work for many others, and so I bought a bunch of them, started using them, had a little bit of results, but I wasn't following the regimen every day. But Aaron Dykes in my office did and lost more than 60 pounds. When I saw those results, I said, I better follow my own advice. I started taking the longevity products, and it's been incredible. 37 pounds in 2 months. Our bodies are amazing, and God gave us an incredible gift. But if our body doesn't have the tools it needs, all of the vitamins, all of the minerals, and the other key essential trace elements, we're not going to be healthy. Folks, this isn't hype. I only bring to my listeners products that I've tried myself that I truly believe in. And the amazing supplements available at InfoWarsTeam.com have certainly delivered my life. I hope you'll give them a try. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
Are you still a traditional smoker? Now experience a new lifestyle and try vaping with e-cigarettes by LeSig. Imagine no ashes, stains, nasty smell, or coughing and hacking. With LeSig e-cigarettes' revolutionary microelectronic technology, rechargeable battery, and unique replaceable cartridge, you'll get all the benefits and satisfaction of smoking without the hazards. Choose your taste from a wide variety of our new American-made Vaporeon e-liquids at LeSig.com. And LeSig smokes the competition by serving thousands of worldwide customers with real people customer service, fast, free, same-day shipping, and a 30-day warranty and satisfaction guarantee. So are you ready for a new vaping lifestyle? Then call 870-518-4307. That's 870-518-4307. Or visit LeSig.com, spelled L-E-C-I-G.com. LeSig e-cigarettes for today's modern smoker.
This year, about one in every 50 U.S. homes will have a break-in. That's almost one per block. Will that one home be yours? Well, I found an amazing little gadget to keep the bad guys fooled, and it's called Fake TV. Fake TV is a low-cost, small electronic security device that makes it look like someone is home watching TV. When you go on summer vacation, yes, get rid of the obvious signs you're away by stopping the mail and the paper, but go a step further in fooling crooks with Fake TV. At only $34.95, what? That can't be right. Yes, for only $34.95, Fake TV could be the difference between coming home to a secure house or one that's been ransacked and all your possessions gone. Fake TV simulates the light from a real TV and can be programmed just like a lamp on a timer. Use Fake TV in any room for just $34.95 and get additional Fake TVs for only $29.95. Go to FakeTV.com or call 1-877-5-FAKE-TV, 877-5-FAKE-TV, or go to FakeTV.com. For safety, security, and peace of mind, use Fake TV.
what the system does. It takes our best soldiers and deploys them 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times, knowing that it's going to wreck psychologically more than 30% of them. World War I, World War II, they would not make you serve more than one tour. My grandfather only had to fly 22 missions over Europe and never wanted to talk about it and told everybody he was a cook in the Army Air Corps. And he was after his 20-something missions. He was made the head cook, you know, over a group. But after, of course, he died and years later dig into his stuff. So, you know, these soldiers, it's not fun. I mean, the old-timers I knew never wanted to talk about World War II. 1 year. I mean, some of them volunteered to go longer. 1 year overseas. Imagine year after year after year after year after year. And then they put them on Prozac, like that Bales sergeant. And they're going to put him in prison. And I'm not saying what he did is, what do you do when somebody's on a psychotropic drug and been in four tours and had part of their foot blown off and says, I don't want to go back? Oh, let's just send you right back over there then. I mean, it's the drugs that are doing this. And it's a time bomb. You know, the government says the troops are the number one threat in terrorism. They're not saying number one threat going postal. There is that problem because a small percentage will. But do you get a small percentage of millions of people that have been in these different tours of the last decade? There's a couple million that have been in and out. It is a time bomb. By the way, it's a time bomb for police and others because the police have got post-traumatic stress disorder, most of them veterans. The veterans they're pulling over just had a bad day at work or a bad day with the wife. Time bomb. But the government's not talking about that. It's saying, no, they're going to be terrorists. And the number one threat is troops detonating improvised explosive devices. That's what they teach in the public manuals. We broke it back when it was still secret. Every police department's trained that you will, I could open the phones up to police, they'll call in and tell you. You will face veterans with bombs. And I guess when they start hyping it up enough and do a few, that'll put the idea in people's heads, there might actually be some real ones. See, I've also studied the psychological warfare system. The globalists are able to hype things and then actually prime the pump and do a few of their own terror attacks and then actually get some copycatters. Kind of like school shootings. You advertise it enough, talk about it. What do you do when you're upset about your life? You're 14. Well, get daddy's shotgun and shoot some people. Just like death education starting federally in the early 90s, massively. There's mainline, you know, ABC News even reported on this. Massive increases in people committing suicide. Yeah, you think 12-year-old girls are thinking about how to commit suicide until it becomes a big drama queen thing? And let us show you in the death education class how to commit suicide. That's what they've shown with sexual education. It's one thing if we're doing it to people, you know, 13, 14, 15, and just giving them the facts in health class. And, hey, here's some diseases. You better look out. But no, when they start teaching 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10-year-olds, those kids were never even thinking about sex. Now it's in their mind. Now it's in their mind. And it's the same thing. Just like police will tell you, when some nut jumps off a famous building, they know to station people in the next few days because other people are going to see it in the news and go, I'm going to do that. I'm going to do that. That's how this works. And all these movies and stuff about how right-wingers are going to kill cops and hyping it, that's putting it in people's minds. I want to come back and go to, who's been holding the longest here, Aaron in Nevada, Minnesota National Guard. Then we're going to go to other military people that are holding. Michael on the East Coast says he's CIA. Well, that's pretty common nowadays, might be. 800-259-9231. The next hour is only 60 seconds away. I'm Alex Jones of InfoWars.com.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNLive.com today.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for survivalseedbank.com.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, it's in the USA Today and most other papers, just all over the place. They say the war against Al-Qaeda is almost over, and well, the good guys won, but guess what? Now the American people are the terrorists, and neocon think tank cites Cleveland bust of white anarchists to push police state surveillance, because, you know, there's just bombers everywhere, folks. Those returning veterans, those evil anarchists, just what will we do without Homeland Security working for the foreign banks, hijacking the country? I mean, thank goodness they're there. Talking to military, but now I also want to open the phones up for military who are dressing up in police uniforms, part of Brigade Homeland and other operations. I know Marines are involved as well. For decades, raiding gun dealers and others in high threat warrant service, or police who've been involved in this can call in. I got documents. I know what's going on. Why don't you talk about it? You know, it's super illegal. It's super secret takeover, and it's getting bigger. Under the surface, it's kind of like there's so many roaches under the carpet. There's so much corruption that the carpet is like moving. The whole thing is moving. This is bad. And we need to talk about it so we can have a debate about it so we can stop it. Let's go to Aaron in Nevada, Minnesota National Guard Info. Go ahead. Thank you.
Hey, thank you, Alex. Well, I'm in a disagreement, not with you this time, but with Paul Watson's article from yesterday about U.S. troops in Minnesota. I have some very good information to let me tell you about it. Let me finish.
Okay.
Okay, here's the thing. That article was very misleading. I thought I would do some fact-checking. So I contacted some people I know at NORTHCOM, and also people at Minnesota National Guard. They took a look at the article. They thought it was a little bit biased, a little bit misleading. So they got a hold of the lieutenant colonel that actually was in the command of that Minnesota operation that you guys are reporting on. And he made an unclassified response and about what actually
you
happened.
You sound like a total moron twit. Put him on hold. He made an unclassified statement. Oh, we have to have classification. Things have to be classified when we're talking to the enemy American people. What does that mean, an unclassified statement about Minnesota National Guard troops marching around the streets? Buddy, I've been myself to more than 20 drills and events with troops, regular Army, you name it, marching around Marines. I've had my cameraman and myself told to turn our cameras off and threatened. I have seen it. And you're calling in saying I'm misleading, saying Paul Watson's doing all this. We get things wrong every once in a while, but you're just, you sound so arrogant and just so classified. Like, and you smacked. Look, there's more CIA in this country than there are pebbles at Pebble Beach. You know, it's like, oh, classified, oh, secret, oh, tell us what the colonel said. He told us something that wasn't classified. Tell me about it. Tell me about troops and Brigade Homeland and TSA at street corner checkpoints. Am I lying about that? Go ahead. or pause with your big authority to play games. Going to play more mind games?
Anyways, I'll suffer your personal insults.
Shut up and tell me why you're telling me about classified.
It's unclassified, I said.
Yeah, I know. You're like, he told me something unclassified. It shouldn't be classified if it's domestic operations in this country. You know what posse comitatus is?
Yeah, and that's the thing. You don't. Paul Watson doesn't seem to know the difference between active and reservist. I made that clear in the whole story that I did on it.
You know what? You are unbelievable. There are troops of every type acclimating the public here, and you want to call in with no facts and tell me I'm wrong. Stay there. I'll give you another minute on the other side, P-Brain.
Right now, the average family spends one-fourth of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
$4, $5, $6, even $7 a gallon? According to fuel industry insiders and economic experts, those are the forecasted fuel prices, with no end in sight. Fight back fuel prices with a fuel saver from AirFusionSystems.com. These fuel savers can save you from 20 to 40%. They're designed to fit any vehicle, from compacts to SUVs to transport trucks. The fuel saver works on all gas, diesel, even propane engines. Easy do-it-yourself installation in about 15 minutes. And the best part? No engine modifications, no computer chipping, no running wires, no chemicals, no water, no running costs, and no maintenance. And these fuel savers come complete with all parts and accessories. See how it works at AirFusionSystems.com, spelled AirFusion Systems.com. Or call 888-887-9981. 888-887-9981. Fuel savers from AirFusionSystems.com. Save fuel, save money, save Earth.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gusset's got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it. Others don't.
The Genesis Communications Radio Network proudly presents The Alex Jones Show, because there's a war on for your mind.
All right, if you just joined us, I'm taking military calls from the military. Do they believe in this fable that Osama bin Laden was killed? So a guy calls in, says Minnesota National Guard info. I said I'm taking calls on the subject, do you believe in the bin Laden thing? The guy is obviously upset, and he plays these little mind games, and that's the quickest way to get me just angry. He's like, okay, I've got some information, you're wrong, if you'll just be quiet. And then he pauses about 4 seconds, and I'm wondering, is the guy's phone gone? And then as soon as I talk, he jumps in. It's like a mind game. I'm like, okay, it's like sticking your hand out, then when somebody goes to shake it, you pull your hand back. I'm not 5 years old, son. And Then he goes into your disinformation, Paul Watson, Minnesota troops up there. Well, difference between active duty and not active duty. And I'm like, listen. He goes, and the colonel made a non-classified statement, like getting off creamily on talking about classification, this whole religion, when they get on the air and they talk about the CIA, and everybody starts getting all excited. Speaking of CIA, we got Michael East Coast says he's CIA, and everybody gets all excited. Oh, CIA, oh my, I mean, CIA, that's like saying you work for FedEx or something. It's a gigantic, huge army. And side issue, the point is that I start blowing up at him and calling him a punk. So for that, I apologize. It's just there's army checkpoints all over the country, TSA. In San Antonio, they've got MPs out at the Riverwalk trying to search people. They've got police all over the country arresting people for filming them in public. Total surveillance. The CIA director says they're using appliances to spy on people without warrants. Google puts out press releases admitting they're using cameras and onboard microphones to watch people. Google has been caught now stealing username and passcodes with wireless trucks and cars. Told you that years ago. Everything is beyond insane. World governments being set up. I can't go to the kite festival now without troops. I can't go to Houston without having them come after my genitals, the TSA pervs, searching bags without warrants. They're confirming that they're dressing up in weird, made-up local police jurisdiction outfits. I mean, this is right out of Romancing the Stone, where Colonel Zorro, or whatever his name is always wearing a new uniform. I mean, this is bad. And I think the guy's upset. I'm going to try to do an MO here on him. Either he's got family or he himself has been involved in police actions in the military, dressing up, and he's very upset hearing the military call in and say 9/11's an inside job, hearing the military call in and say the bin Laden thing's fake. It's freaking him out, and he can't handle it. Let me just say this to you right now. Aaron, what do you do? Okay, are you in the military? Are you in the Minnesota Guard? Why are you so upset about us exposing the fact that we're all being acclimated to different types of military occupation?
Okay, first off, I'm not upset. But anyways, what am I? I am a reporter in the alternative media, just like you. And I think a reporter has a duty to get both sides of the story.
Okay, P-Brain, shut up for a minute. P-Brain, you're a P-Brain. I mean, I just cannot stand P-Brains. I'm going to let you talk. I'm going to shut up for 1 minute, but I got to say this. You came out and called my reporter was terrible when Watson's the best I've got. He's awesome. He's super smart. I love him. Does a great job. And then I go, okay, show me the goods where Paul's wrong, because every once in a while we're wrong. We want to change it. And then it's just like, well, I talked to the colonel and the classified, unclassified operation and all this, and I want the goods. What did Paul say that wasn't right? Tell me in general that they aren't militarizing this country and that we aren't in trouble. Now, bring the goods. Deliver the goods. Or is this just about you being a little wimp that's jealous of how big this show is? Show me the goods right now, and then I got to go to other callers.
I sent the goods yesterday to writers at Infowars.com, all right?
Okay, what are the goods then? What are the goods? Tell me on air now. How am I wrong? How am I scum? How am I bad? I want to know. Tell me now!
Those guys are under the command of the state of Minnesota, the governor. So they're not U.S. troops marching around. Those weapons had blanks in them, and there's all kinds of details.
Oh, you know what? Oh, did you know that under... No, put him on hold. Oh, okay, there you go. See, he wants troops all over. Buddy, I got National Guard, regular Army, regular Marines. Have you seen Police State for the Rise? Guys, type in armed Marines in Alabama or Marines at DWI checkpoints. It's so incredible. The point is that they've already federalized the National Guard under the states and the governor. They federalized the National Guard. Yes, the governor still has some control. I've actually read the John Warner Defense Authorization Act 2007 that began to federalize them. I mean, I guess gun confiscation didn't happen in Katrina, and it was a joint operation with regular Army, big Army. And I'm sorry, go ahead, continue. Go ahead and scream at me. I like that. That's good. Come on.
Well, you can only, what do you expect? You know, I have my limits, too. Anyways, they're not on 24-hour-7 federalization. They go off and on. See, another thing, you don't understand all the details, man.
I know. That's I'm not into the classification, and I haven't been dyed in the wool with your esprit de corps. I'm a nobody. I'm a civilian. I'm a scum American, and I'm wrong. I'm wrong. There's not troops. There's not TSA. There's not secret police. They didn't kill that chicken farmer. Everything's fine. Oh, let me ask you, do you believe that bin Laden was really killed last year by Barry Sotero?
No, and I'm not arguing. I like Paul Watson, too, but you got that Steve Puke cynic on here who calls for Jeb Bush to be on the ticket, and Ron Paul is just a medical doctor. Let me tell you something, Puke cynic. You're just a shrink.
Well, listen, here's the deal with Pachinik. Pachinik now has come out against Petraeus and all that. These are just people he knows, and I mean, he is a very interesting character. I'll just leave it at that. And he's a real person, and he got, you know, mad earlier when I was running on like I do, which is fine. He didn't really get mad. He said, look, Alex, this is a diversion from what I wanted to cover. I'll come back on when it's the bin Laden thing, and I actually apologize, you know, for doing what I do, but I'm real. And so I'm sorry for yelling and screaming at you, but let me just ask you this question. Are they not in the process of Homeland Security, of militarizing everything? I mean, is that not going on?
Explanation. Again, I'm just a reporter. I'm trying to get both sides.
Okay, what else is wrong? What else? I'm trying to get both sides. Hey, is there both sides if somebody walks up to your mother and beats her brains out with a baseball bat for no reason?
Of course not.
Okay, listen, our country is turning into a classical, flaming, out-of-control police state.
No, those guys are sworn to uphold the Constitution.
Oh,
man.
You got
to
be a... Sir, have you heard the military calling in? They know what's going on is wrong. I can't go to the kite festival now without military out there trying to grab my... thank you for the call. Let's go to Michael before he hangs up. East Coast says he's CIA. I got to hear this. So what part of the CIA are you in, Michael? Oh, yes, this is very nice.
40% of all high school graduates do not pass the Armed Forces entrance exam. And when you think of how they have compartmental stupidity in the military and other agencies across the United States, you wonder what's going on. And when you find out what is going on at Camp Perry, otherwise known as the Armed Forces Experimental Training Activity, they've had unprecedented infrastructure growth, fiber optics lines, advanced communication systems, and it's full of all these independent contractors that have watered down America's mission. As far as Osama bin Laden, when you think of the time from Bush to Obama, why do you think it took so long? And they're dragging their feet to prop up the military-industrial complex. How many agents do you think are in Iran that are trying to disrupt and use guerrilla tactics? None. Hardly. Maybe 50 at the most. And that's the thing. America's future is in the balance right now. And the mindset in Washington, our elected officials could care less of what's going on with America because they've been manipulated by the lobbyists. And they're not doing what's in the best interest of America, especially when you look at the manufacturing base in America. In the 1970s, 25% of all jobs were in manufacturing, and now we're looking at 9%. And the 9% is mostly military industrial complex. We've got to do something to bring up this economy. We've got to have a politician that is going to inspire a nation with down-to-earth concrete ideas.
So I take it you don't believe that they killed the Easter Bunny last year in Pakistan?
Yeah, well, the biggest thing about these military jackboot state stuff that you talk about, they're putting a lot of armed forces people in police positions. If they come back and they don't have a job, they're going to drink and take drugs and they're going to shoot people up. They've got to have something to do. And if
they've
got to
shoot up the American people, I agree. Give them something
to
do.
And the next thing you know, we're going to have a 10 to 15% real unemployment rate. And we've been propping up nations with our bases across the globe. We're subsidizing economies across the world with our military when we should start focusing on...
Sir, I hear you. Great points. We've got active police. Will in Texas has info on Farmer. Interesting call, sir. Okay, Will, you're a police officer. What's your news?
Hey, Alex, good afternoon.
Are you enjoying the ranting?
Yeah, I always enjoy a good rant, especially on InfoWars. I'm originally from Metro Atlanta in Georgia, and I worked in law enforcement. It's where I cut my teeth in law enforcement, was actually in the Roswell area in Fulton County. And one of the things I want to point out is Fulton County and Metro Atlanta is unique that they have a sheriff's office and a marshal's office.
Okay,
and
that's what it is.
Yeah, it's actually two different divisions of law enforcement. The sheriff is an elected constitutional official, and the marshal is an appointed position from the Board of Commissioners. And the marshal's position and his deputy marshals, mainly what they're there for is the movement of inmates from pretrial detention centers to going forward for trial and this sort of thing. If you can imagine, when they leave jail and go to the courthouse, the marshals are kind of the ones who kind of sit and babysit the inmates as they're awaiting their arraignments or court hearings and this sort of thing. It's highly unusual to me that the marshals would be the one doing the civil process on the chicken man and Roswell.
Well, my issue is we've called all these groups and the papers say everyone denies they did it. And then now this fella called in who sounded credible, and everything he said tumbled into place because I know this goes on, and said no, Brigade Homeland raided the house.
Throw a little more info towards you, Alex. When your reporters went to what you're calling, it looks like a Capitol building, Roswell City Hall, you encountered some officers that were not Roswell police officers proper. What they actually are municipal complex police officers. They work for City Hall. They do not work for the police department. If you can imagine, they're kind of trumped-up bailiffs that work for the city.
No, I understand. Roswell. They were wearing the same uniforms, yeah. And we were wondering why the captain was saying, we'll talk to this sergeant, he's in charge, and we're like, what?
Exactly. It didn't make sense, right? So I actually know someone, trained and worked with someone who works at the municipal complex as a municipal complex police officer, and I put a call into him after hearing your reporting because, to tell you the truth, I'm out of contact with home. I didn't know this kind of stuff was going on. I knew the chicken man. He was a good guy. I used to get free eggs from him. I mean, he was a real nice fellow. And I made a phone call to this gentleman that I know that works for the municipal complex and asked him, hey, what the hell's going on? And pretty much what he told me was we had nothing to do with it, and that's as much as he would tell me.
What do you think about everybody acting scared and no one saying who actually went there or what happened? And we say, go ahead.
No, a lot of times when you have guys that have 15, 16 years invested into the retirement system, they're going to not rock the boat. They're going to go and there's going to be a party line. Usually there's interoffice memorandums that come out saying, hey, listen, refer reporters or whomever to this person and you're not to say anything. And I think in this particular case, that's what happened. But I will tell you, knowing how it works in Fulton County, Georgia, it is, it's real suspicious to me that the Fulton County Marshals would be out doing civil service, especially when you add into this factor, Alex. Supposedly, the chicken man had, said that he wasn't going to be taken alive. At least that's kind of the party line of what's being said. Why in the world would you not send the sheriff's office to deal with criminal situations, if there was going to be some sort of barricade situation or that kind of thing, why would they not go out and
Let me say this. I've got the documents. I've talked to the people. Are you aware? Have you heard about the Fort Hood? Because you're saying you're calling from Texas. Did you know Fort Hood responds covertly with troops to aid police on a routine basis all over the state?
Not from Fort Hood, Alex, but I have been part of situations where we've had troops from Camp Bullis and Fort Sam Houston coming out in quote-unquote support missions. There have been several incidents that I know personally of down in the Valley of Texas where local law enforcement on the county level and federal troops, and I know you had the one guy who was trying to make the differentiation between National Guard, Reserve, and active duty troops, where they were all working side by side. So, yeah, I'm
Look,
aware.
Look, my cousin, before he got deployed again, he's been in the Army 20-something years, his job is merging the National Guard with Big Army out at Bergstrom. I mean, they're merging. I'm sure they got different patches, but they're merging. And that's why I started blowing up at the guy, because He was just making stuff up, basically, saying, well, they're just National Guard under the governor. There's nothing wrong with this. The point is, we got military coming on our ears now. They're getting us ready, is my point. Man, we're...
And this is my opinion, I guess you would say, but the traditional mission of National Guard, you know, from the time of Eisenhower up has been... they answer to the governor. Well, of course, that's changed over the last 40, 50 years. Something that we have to keep in mind, though, is with the centralization of these council of governors, you have to understand that there are governors in this country that no longer answer to the people of the state. They're actually answering to federal authorities.
No, that's what the John Warner Defense Authorization Act says. It's turning the National Guard from the governors into this federal system, and it says that council's in control, and it's got language in there about insurrection in states and even legislatures and things. Why is the central government gearing up to take over the states? I mean, they admit they are now. This is not... Look, Texas, when they unanimously voted in the House to arrest TSA that grabbed people's private parts, it's illegal. The feds threatened a blockade and said they'd back it up with force. I mean, what is that?
Well, I think you also have to look at the guys, you know, like Rick Perry and Lieutenant Governor Dewhurst that pretty much answer to the federal authorities anyways. The people spoke, their representatives spoke, and the central government came in and squashed it.
And that's why I get so mad at that guy. I mean, the issue is I have to sit there and argue with my wife about not leaving this country. I mean, I believe all this. I know it's real. I've been driven crazy by it. I understand that. But the point is, I can't believe this is going to happen. I mean, it's going to get bad. I mean, I tell you, they didn't set all this up for no reason. It's all I'm telling everybody is we have got to get the word out somehow so this doesn't happen.
I'm going to say things that you already know, Alex, but in my time, I just went into my 12th year of law enforcement, and in my time, I have seen a dramatic change really over the last decade of kind of an old guard that's going out and kind of the militarization of law enforcement. And one of the things that I have noticed is it really has been an ever-encroaching federalization of law enforcement to where now there is a area of training through FEMA that's managing civil unrest and threats. This is becoming required training for all new law enforcement that are going through the academies, not just here in Texas, but really kind of nationwide, that it is teaching there will be civil unrest. There is going to be people in the street and the appropriate ways, according to FEMA, of how to deal with them.
Well, and that's the general training, but from what I've seen in the news and documents, the intelligence units and the SWAT teams, at least they said this in the news, in the last 6 years, are all getting training that they, quote, will face veterans with IEDs. So you've...
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah, something else, too, is, and to me it all comes back to money and through federal grant programs, Alex. And one of the things that I have seen is, especially with kind of large agencies, regional agencies, and I'm talking like, you know, your city of San Antonio and this sort of thing, city of Austin, that have large SWAT teams, there is a federalization of those SWAT teams into becoming what are called Tier 1 agencies, Tier 1 SWAT teams. And pretty much this means that you're going to have like an EOD team, like the bomb techs. You're going to have two ready, an A team and a B team of SWAT teams and this sort of thing. And they answer to, in our region, at least Region 6, they answer to FEMA. And say, for example, and this is not going under what we have protected in our state here in Texas of mutual aid. This is through FEMA. So if we had a natural disaster, this, say, city of Austin, FEMA would tell city of Austin, hey, report to, and you can fill in the blank.
And remember what happened in New Orleans. They wouldn't go under FEMA command. So as the storm hits, this is CBS News. They jam cell phones of the police. Then they go cut the tower down on the radio. The police have to guard it. And then FEMA orders everybody to stand down and then says, oh, look, the city couldn't respond. And then they show film footage of a few of the crazy cops robbing Walmart to make the image of only FEMA can save you. Oh, and then FEMA screws up, so they need more power. See the problem, reaction, solution? Blocking the Coast Guard, bringing in the fuel, blocking all the local police that came to help and firefighters from all over the country, and then letting it turn into a hellhole for 5 days and rolling in behind that the military to take guns. I mean, that is what they did.
Well, I think a lot of people get, you know, and having conversations recently and me referencing false flags, you know, you don't have to have a Gulf of Tonkin or a World Trade Center for a false flag. Just inactivity in itself is provoking the false flag. And like it, the example that you were just giving, the inaction of local authorities at direction of FEMA in itself creates the crisis.
20 years ago, 2 days ago, was the L.A. riots. The police stood down and pulled back and said, well, we'll get blamed if we do anything, and then let them shoot firefighters who still went in. And I've got articles breaking that down today where the media and the police will not respond when whites are attacked. And it's on record now. See, and again, this is very dangerous because they're trying to elicit some type of major crisis right now so the feds can come fluttering in as everybody's savior. Thank you, Will. Great call. Great information. See, folks, all police are being trained that the veterans are terrorists and are going to kill them. It's totally made up. Yeah, veterans might go wild to shoot somebody, but they're a small person. They're not going to be bombing anybody. I mean, that is just, they're telling him you will face veterans with bombs. I mean, this is ridiculous. Something special coming up after the break. Stay with us.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at Infowars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. Infowars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at Infowars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup, insurance, and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
Here in about a minute, we're going to call the Westfields Marriott in Chantilly, Virginia again. because we know that David Rockefeller a lot of times shines it up under some names, and we've done research, some of the listeners have. We believe it is under Council of Americas. So we're going to call their front desk. We're also going to call some other places there at the big center, because the Bilderberg Group, we're 95, well, Jim Tucker says 99% sure, and I believe him, but we're really finding out early this year how fortuitous that it's coming up May 29th through June 3rd. That means they'll shut the hotel down the 29th. It'll really start the next day, and I'm going to be there. It's in the U.S. I'm going. But we're trying to ferret out info and get them to admit it. That would be nice. And so we're just going to do this on air right now. Call the front desk, please. Here we go. Last time I kind of acted goofy. We'll see what happens here. I do this stuff too much.
Thank you, Paul Westfield. Mary, how can
I
help you?
Hi. I was inquiring about the event coming up with the Council of Americas, the 29th of this month to the 3rd of June. And I'd like to find out exactly when I should arrive for that, what time that starts.
We don't get information about the group at the hotel until about 2 or 3 days prior to their arrival.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I can barely hear you. What did you say?
We do not have the information of who is coming in that far out.
Okay, well, can I book a room, actually two rooms with king-size beds, please? From the, let me see, that'd be May 31st to June 3rd. Can I book that right now, please?
Oh, certainly. Let me give you a reservation.
Okay, thank you. Here we go. And then we'll get back to them.
To ensure high quality service, your conversation may be recorded. Please see our privacy statement at Marriott.com to understand how
we surveil everything. Enjoy the fluoride water.
Are assisting other guests.
Let your mind drift away.
Remain on the line, and the next available representative will be with you shortly.
I want to point out they're going to let me book that day.
Revived, refreshed, and re-energized. Whether you're traveling on business or leisure, we will make sure you're ready to go.
And hang out with David Rockefeller? Busy day over at the Marriott. She just sent me to reservations, which is their big centralized system, probably somewhere else. Probably right at NSA headquarters that's down the street. Oh, boy. Tell you what, call the pub. Call the pub. Disconnect this. We'll call back. We need to do this behind the scenes as legwork to totally confirm this, but I'll kill two birds with one stone. We'll just start doing everything here on the air, including real reservations. Because my son is begging to go. He is 9 years old. I think I should take him to Bilderberg. I think my wife will let me. Yep.
How about the speaker? Can I help you?
I'm sorry, sir. You sound a little bit muffled. I don't know if it's my phone system that's on a string and yarn, but or tin cans. What did you say?
This is Wellington Pub. Abdul is speaking. What can I help you?
Oh, yes, sir. Are you there in the pub right now?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Hey, listen, I'd like to know if I could reserve a couple tables for a birthday party for my friend coming up, say, the evening of June 1st.
Okay, you need to talk to our manager. I'm sorry, he can take your reservation. Can you hold a second?
Yes, sir. But I mean, I can still be in there, right, even though there's that special conference coming up?
Okay. I can't tell you because I don't have access to the computer, and they can check the computer, everything. He can tell you all details, everything.
Great. So, but I mean, you are there in Chantilly yourself, right?
Yeah.
All right, good. Sure. Is there like an event planner I can talk to?
Hold on 1 second.
Please. Okay, thank you so much. Da-da-da. All right, that's enough. You guys are begging for an encore. La 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 la.
How can he tell her he loves her?
Yeah, let me hear their music instead of ours. That's Bilderberg music versus ours. Let me hear ours. Oh, man, here we go.
Leslie, how may I help you?
Hey, I'd like to see about booking like a special party or something in one of your restaurants on June 1st, a birthday party for my friend.
Sure, may I ask who's calling?
Sure, this is Alex Jones, and I'd like to have a birthday party for David Rockefeller, who's staying there that evening.
Okay. And Alex, how many people were you estimating for the event?
Well, I mean, it depends on how big an area I could get. I mean, I know, I guess the Council of America's meeting is going to be there, and that's a couple hundred people. I was thinking I'd bring 10 or 15.
So about 10 or 15, and you're looking to do something in the restaurant? Have you been to our property before?
Yes, I have. Yes, okay. I was there 4 years ago in your lovely little English-style pub.
Yeah.
And then there's also the bigger dining room area.
Perfect. Okay. Can I take down your information and have a restaurant manager contact you?
Sure. So the hotel is open. I mean, it's not a closed conference then, because I thought I was coming to a closed conference.
I will be more than happy to look into that for you. Usually the pub is still open. What was the name of the conference again, so I can take that down?
It's going to be Council of the Americas. I'm sure you've heard about the Bilderberg meeting that's coming to town.
Oh, you know what? I am actually new, so I apologize. I have not.
You have not heard of that?
I have not. I've only just been here about a week.
Have you heard of David Rockefeller?
No, I haven't.
Have you heard of Henry Kissinger?
No.
Have you heard of Count Dracula?
Yes.
Same person.
Oh, okay. Alex, what is the best contact number for you?
The best contact number for me is 512.
And is there an email address I can take down as well?
Yes, that would be...
And that's R-I-D-E-R-F?
Absolutely. And can you transfer me back to reservations?
Sure.
But I mean, can I do reservations there at that hotel so they know what the rooms are like and stuff? Or does that have to be through the central system?
It usually goes through the central system.
Doesn't everything these days?
It unfortunately does. I do apologize. I will absolutely have somebody from the restaurant follow up with you in regards to this event. And I will create the reservation.
Thank you. Lord, Mr. Rockefeller will enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is ridiculous. Whoever thought calling and booking a hotel could be so much fun? You like my little line about Count Dracula? Oh, boy. La, 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 la. What's funnier is there a thing where it's like, let your mind drift away, and I'm like, on the fluoride. Or go back to their lovely music. Is this what you listen to on the elevator to hell? She disconnected us? Okay, that's it. You gotta watch the nice ones. Give me an example of some of the numbers you've got in there. Who can we call? I know one ingenious guy called David Rockefeller and got him on the line and kept doing it at like 5 a.m. and calling my room and letting me hear David Rockefeller. Hold on. This actually happened. And the guy told me he taped it. He said, I don't think I'm comfortable giving this to you. And I'm like, okay. It's like, oh, let you talk to that. David's like, all right, I'm back. Well, may I help you, young man? That actually happened. I mean, my life is so weird. Folks, when you actually get involved in the real world, it is beyond bizarre. What is going on here? An award-winning Sunday champagne brunch is offered weekly. On holidays, including Easter, Mother's Day, Father's Day, Thanksgiving, and Christmas Day, we will feature specialty brunches sure to please. Hey, Jim Tucker, what do you think David Rockefeller's doing there right now? Probably slurping his soup. Okay, never mind. That's a Paul Watson joke. National Guard, let's talk to Terry. Guys, I need the entire crew because I know Tucker tried and I know other people tried. I want us ourselves to be refused booking because I want to be booked in earlier. When they refuse us those days, which Tucker says they've already tried as well. I want to confirm it myself, though. Trust but verify. And then regardless, get me like at least the day before so they can accuse me of trying to steal vases and pull fire alarms, you know, that they do, and then blame me and then cuss at me and threaten me and everything else they do. So I want to make sure we're there for that fun before we move to the next hotel. Thank you. Let's go ahead and go to Terry in Arizona. Welcome, sir.
Hello, Alex. Wow, that was classic, the Count Dracula deal. I was laughing my tail off. I too, it was such a coincidence that you mentioned the National Guard in the L.A. riots, because I was there in 91, 92, right in that area. And at the end, right prior to going into L.A., it was told on the media that we had no ammo. We did have ammo. We had 40 rounds apiece, okay, because martial law had set in the whole city. Now, I couldn't understand why it was reported in the media that they didn't have any ammo, because that caused people to rise up, and, of course, martial law had set in. Well, you would have got shot. And at the end of the riots, there was another thing that happened that I found very, very strange. And I've done my homework, too, with the IMF, the World Bank. I did my own homework just like you have. And at the end of the riots, two big busloads, this was reported on the news, at least I didn't know about it, two big busloads of generals all over the world, and I'm sure they had a lot to do with the UN. And one of the generals asked, why did not we come into LA with tanks blaring? Okay, now these are, I'm sure, our allies. Okay, it wouldn't be any enemies there, but I just thought that was very strange that they asked our generals that during the LA riot. Another thing that I want to make known to you, and I don't know if you heard about it, I have not heard you mention it on your show, but the National Security Strategy, have you heard of it?
Yes, they put a new one out every year.
Well, this national security strategy was written by President Barack Obama of 2010, May 10th.
Yes.
You know what he called? I read the whole report.
Well, they say the new threat is not Al-Qaeda, it's domestic terrorism. I did see that.
Right, right. Well, I totally believe what you're saying. They're federalizing everything. It's happening. I see it. And only people that are educated on it will see it. But my point is about the national security strategy.
Sure.
Which it goes along with what you're saying with this one world international order. They call it.
Now, I'm on it. I'm on the National Security Strategy 2010, whitehouse.gov. Okay, tell me about it.
Yeah, and it's called, and what it called for. Okay, and it blew my mouth. My mouth hit the floor. They called for the World Bank and the IMF, military to joint military. When it says military, and this is written by the President of the United States, so that means he can activate National Guard Reserve into one military at a moment's call. Okay, he has that power. Okay, but it says military to joint military. That's NATO. Okay, IMF. Okay, IMF is International Monetary Fund, and that's a bank. Okay, so everything you're saying coincides with what's going on in the world.
No, there it is. I searched what you just said, and there it is. You just type in National Security Strategy 2010.
Yeah, and here's the thing. The crazy thing about this is nobody reported it. CNN didn't report it.
Look. Accelerate sustainable development. Yeah, we reported on that. Agenda 21 was in the National Security Strategy. Wow, this thing is a treasure trove of evil.
It's totally global, and it's all intertwined, especially with what's going on over there in the EU. It's crazy that, especially that guy that nobody's heard of, you know, that got elected with only 8% of the vote. I mean, how in the heck Barack Obama, a black man, got elected with 56% of the vote out of 350 million people? And you ask, how did this guy become president of all of Europe? I don't know. But you know who I'm talking about. But this stuff is going on. It is happening. And I hear you every day. I love your show. I am a Christian. I believe in God. I know what's going on. And I just pray for you, and I pray for your show. Good show. I love you, and I'll yield back the floor.
Sir, I appreciate you as well. John Bound did just call and get through and tried to book and was denied. Did you get denied from booking it the day before, the 28th? Yeah. So you got denied the 29th to the 30th. Yeah. So what I'm saying is go ahead and call back and book the day before, please.
Call back, book the 28th.
Yes, and book it under, exactly. Book it under Bilderberg. No, don't do that.
I tried Council of America's.
Oh, yeah, you said I'd like to book under Council of America's, and what'd they say?
He hadn't heard of Council. I said, I'd like to book under Council of America's, like that.
Oh.
He took me seriously. So.
Really?
But he said, we haven't heard of Council of America's.
And then you said, are you on air right now on the mic?
Yes.
All right, okay, great. Might get closer to it. I'm making the guys start talking on air so they actually hear the other side of what's going on. So you just called him and give us the dialogue.
It sounded like a central office. I verified that it was for the Chantilly between the 29th and the 3rd, and there were no rooms available. He asked me if I was with a conference. I said that I was with the Council of Americas. And he said he'd never heard of that, that wasn't on the list. And so if we have any other names, I'll try them with different voices.
Oh, boy. Well, that makes it easy that it's there. What a perfect place to bullhorn them. And Richard N. Haas, the head of the CFR, came out and just glares, just like going, because there's this one spot where the conference rooms, most of it, you're like 500 yards back from the road. But there's one spot where the big conference center sticks out by the road. And they tried to order the police to not let us get up close, but the police were like, well, it is a city sidewalk. We'll see what happens this year. Some areas of this country, though, they'd say, get them, and the cops would pull out their billy clubs and start beating our heads in. We're going to come back and talk to Sam, who's ex-infantry, get his take on the whole bin Laden situation, and Herb, also Air Force. And the question here is, do you believe that Osama Easter Bunny bin Laden was killed last year?
Mother's Day is next week, and Pro Flowers is offering an amazing deal. 1 dozen assorted roses plus a free glass vase for just $19.99. Go to proflowers.com, click on the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter the secret code 7777. But hurry, this incredible deal expires this Friday. Flower prices will skyrocket next week. Order now from Pro Flowers to get huge savings. You pick the delivery date, and it's guaranteed. That's 1 dozen stunning assorted roses, absolutely bursting with color, sent fresh from the fields, and guaranteed to stay fresh and beautiful for at least 7 full days for only $19.99, plus a free glass vase with every order. Remember, flower prices can double, even triple next week. And this incredible special expires this Friday. The only way to get this amazing deal is to go to proflowers.com, click on the radio microphone in the upper right corner, and enter the secret code 7777.
In an emergency situation, would you drink contaminated water? You could if you had the amazing Life Straw from MyPatriotSupply.com. Life Straw is the most advanced personal water filter available today. It filters contaminated water from almost any source. Life Straw is lightweight and compact, perfect for hiking, camping, or in an emergency like a flood. Life Straw is easy to clean, comes with a 1-year warranty, and has been used worldwide since 2005. Get the amazing Life Straw personal water filter at MyPatriotSupply.com. Plus, check out Survival Seed Vault, 20 seed varieties for only $37.95, Tattler canning lids, long-term storable foods as low as $69.95, and much more at MyPatriotSupply.com. Enjoy stress-free shipping on all orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927 or visit MyPatriotSupply.com. That's 866-229-0927, MyPatriotSupply.com, for emergency preparedness, self-reliance, and food independence.
That's the sound of your door being kicked in by an intruder with a single kick. That's the sound of the same door now protected by the Door Sentinel at MySafeDoor.com. Go to MySafeDoor.com right now and watch the amazing video. At MySafeDoor.com, you'll learn how to turn your home into a fortress with the Door Sentinel. 16 kicks later... and the door sentinel is still holding strong. MySafeDoor.com. That's MySafeDoor.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Put on the voice of Judge Smales from Caddyshack to call because they got right through and they denied them to be able to check into the Westfield Marriott to double confirm Bilderberg's there. And then I'll get to your calls. I'm going to go right to Anthony. Well, first Sam and then Herb. And Anthony says he has info on the Easter Bunny, Bin Laden's body. So we're going to talk to him in a minute. Go ahead and dial the Bilderberg. Let me put on my Thurston Howell meets Ted Knight voice. Lovey-dovey.
Mm-hmm. Westfield Marriott, how may I help you?
Yes, ma'am. I'd like to book a room, please.
One moment, sir.
To ensure high-quality service, your conversation...
John, you said this went right through. We could do it quickly this time.
...statement at Marriott.com to understand how we use and protect information. All representatives and assistant other guests, we invite you to remain on the line.
Oh, yes.
The next available representative will...
This is going to be a giant NSA command base from Bilderberg's there.
We know it takes for you to be revived, refreshed, and re-energized.
Like an NSA reunion or something. Equipment piled on tables everywhere. Guys with headphones going, they thought I was out of the hotel. I was still sneaking around in there. Oh my gosh. Truth is so much crazier than fiction. Come on. Hello?
Thank you for calling Marriott Reservations. Brenda speaking. How may I help you?
Hey, I would like to check in to the Westfields Marriott on the 29th of this month and stay through the 3rd. And I'd like I guess it's only 2-3 stories. I'd like a high floor and king-size beds in both rooms.
Oh, so you need 2 rooms?
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Now, is there a conference or anything you're coming in for?
No, I just want to play golf nearby.
Okay, and I'm showing that the hotel is totally sold out.
What? The hotel is completely filled?
The hotel is completely filled.
Is it the Bilderberg Group?
I'm sorry?
Is it the Bilderberg Group coming?
I don't know.
How can it be completely booked? I'm supposed to tee off with Lord Rockefeller.
Well, you know what? You're going to have to get a little bit more pull with Mr. Rockefeller then.
Well, we'll be saying hi to him. Don't worry.
Okay, because what I have, the closest Marriott I have, is the Fairfax at Fair Oaks, which is 6 miles east.
Hey, last time I was there during Bilderberg, the NSA had taken over all the major conference rooms they weren't using. Are they already shipping in the equipment right now?
I have absolutely no idea.
All right, let me ask you a really serious question. Do you believe that Osama bin Laden was really killed last year by Obama?
I have absolutely no idea, but they say so, so...
Well, they say so. They never lie, do they?
Well, you never know.
Well, ma'am, we really appreciate your... Hey, can I book the 28th? Can I check in the day before?
28th of May. No.
I can't? I can't even get in the day before?
Nope. Just double check and see.
Oh, they've even booked that now.
Okay, I can get... Just hold on and let's see how many nights I can get you.
Oh, my gosh. You can get me one night, right? Just the night before?
Let me just double check. I can get 2 nights. I can get 3 nights.
But I thought it's all sold out if I get in on the 28th.
Okay. So, what I can do is I can get 3 nights coming in on the 28th to the 31st.
When is it closed for the conference?
Are you coming in for a conference?
No, but you were saying that the hotel was sold out then.
Well, it is sold out for the 5 nights, but I can do the 28th, the 29th, and the 30th.
Oh, wait, I thought it was closed. I thought it was closed the 29th through the 3rd.
It is, but I'm able to see. I put it in for the 5 nights, so all those nights were sold out. I wasn't able to get all 5 nights in a row.
Oh, okay, great. Hold on one moment.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Right now, the average family spends 1/4 of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.